Oh, yeah, I did go to this, I did go to the staff meeting. Right.
You did, okay.
I did. I was a little bit late, but I got there. They were very appreciative that we were here, that I was there, and appreciated those who had gone before me.
Good.
They made a comment that they really appreciated that, yeah.
Board, like volunteer board that goes?
Well, David was there as well. We were the only two.
Okay.
David.
Femia?
Yeah, Femia.
Is he for ZBA or?
I know, so we were the only two, so they were.
Which board was he representing?
He was representing zoning.
Zoning, okay.
I believe.
Yeah, Raj.
Shall we get started? Yeah, that's true. Apparently Dave needs his own mic.
Yes, yes, we did get that feedback.
Where is it?
Oh, he's.
He must be upstairs, yeah.
He's a professional.
So you wanna get started?
Sure.
We can go, let's get started.
I think we're going.
All right, we'll open the meeting this evening. It's, what, 7:04? And, let's see, the people waiting, why don't we move to the second topic this evening? Wachusett Plaza update regarding Cumberland Farms and the additional site work review on the southerly portion. Now, I know there's been, since the last meeting, I know there's been a lot of back and forth between your engineer and the town engineer. So I think that's certainly helped to facilitate things after the discussion that we had last month. I don't know.
Do you have, is there anything that you wanna present further tonight before we?
Well, no, I think the issues that we have.
You wanna step up to the?
I think the issue that, you know, all the things that we presented to Lane, I think the issue that came back with mainly was the parking, and then we'll talk about the rain garden situation where it is, but.
Okay.
Other than that, I don't think.
When he says parking, he also means the driveway.
The driveway, yeah,
okay.
The access, the whole.
Yep.
That portion of it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I think everything else, I don't think there was.
I had some, I just wanted to make sure that all the connections underground were put back together if they were taken apart. That's all I was, and it seems like that was.
We never took any.
Well, that's what I mean. If Cumberland disconnected something and.
They did.
Repositioned it, as long as it lined up with where it was supposed to be, that's.
Oh, yeah, they did.
And it sounds like that happened.
Yeah.
I don't know if.
They came from.
BHB knew much about it.
Amendment, I think.
Yes.
Yeah, they were fine. Cumberland's all set. They left a stub pipe waiting for a connection, and then I think you're asking, was anything connected to it? And we don't know what was connected to it or why it was connected to it, so that's kind of what we're trying to figure out.
Oh, because, well, I can't tell you. Well, what happened, actually, I'll even show you an email that I had sent to Cumberland. Well, actually, I had a phone call with them back in December, the end of December.
Yeah, I don't remember.
And I said, well, look, I'm not really concerned about anything you're gonna do as long as you don't mess up anything that.
It's already done.
You've got.
That I have.
Sure.
Okay, so I'm gonna show you this email that I sent them. This was after the conversation that I had.
Yeah.
And I says, so, you know, that's my only concern. I don't really care what you do.
Well, that sounds like exactly our concern too.
This is back in January.
Yeah.
Yeah, when they were digging.
So here's her response to me. She wrote, it was Tracy, that she was the lead.
The construction person?
Yeah.
Or the new traffic person?
No, Tracy was the, from.
The construction management?
The construction manager, right. She was the one that kind of coordinated. She was at all your meetings, I guess. Yeah. All right. So she wrote back, hi Andy, when you get a chance, can you send over your DCR approval? If you retrieved it from your car, because I told her it was in my car, I spoke with Luke and he was somewhat confused as to why our application, which is for the CFI pad only, would affect your other pad. That goes to show that I said to them, look, I just want to make sure anything you're doing here doesn't affect anything I'm doing over there. And then she wrote, regardless, we don't want to make problems for you. If we have your approval, it would make things easier. So, I mean, just so you see that. That was on January 7th, that email from her. But I had spoken to her over the phone in December, like before the new year.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. I think that's about the time that we drafted the approval letter for this. And one of the conditions in the approval was that your site plan approval was to become null and void for this site.
Well, no one ever took.
You were CC'd on that, and you were, your representative was Cumberland Farms before the planning board, so they were making all the, it's your property, and we were expecting them to be speaking with you because they were representing, they were your representatives, the documentation you gave us for that leased area. And then what we had asked them in the fall, which I think might have started this, was what are you doing with the drainage and what's going on with the site to the south? They said, we're not doing anything with that. This is only relative to the leased area.
Okay.
So our approval said specifically that the approval is only for the leased area that Cumberland Farms is working, plus the little area in the back for the extra parking. And specifically said that the site plan review for this southerly portion has become null and void.
How can that be? Once I have an
because
approval.
Because the plan's changed.
You can't forget me when I have an approval and it's still there. In other words, they didn't do that anyway. So this is what it came about from it. That's why if you look going forward from this point, what happened is they started realizing, we found out they cut me off there with the pipe, right? How can you do that to me? You can't do that to me. I told you. You can do anything you want, but you don't mess up anything that I've done or I'm going to do. Okay. And it's your responsibility to fix it. So that's why they came back to you guys with an amended plan, enlarging their system that they put in.
Infiltration
system. So, and they connected my pipe to it. Okay, so that's why they did that. Right. They didn't do it because all of a sudden they had some. They did it because I said to them, listen, you shouldn't have done that. You should have made sure that whatever you were doing encompassed my site. Because I never once told them, you can forget about me over here. I mean, look, I don't want to, like I said to them, I don't want to point fingers at them. I don't want to blame them. All I want is it fixed. And they did go forward and fix that. Okay, I mean, so they had to fix it with you, they had to fix it with DCR, and they fixed it. So I'm not sitting here to blame. But even in my conversations with them, we had a conference call, like their engineer, this one, that one, and everyone wanted to start pointing fingers. Well, we sent you a plan. I said, all right, well, you sent me a plan. I'm looking at the picture, and I'm saying, hey, that looks good to me, but I can think, because that looks good to me, you're forgetting me. You know what I'm saying? So, in the end, they realized that they were wrong in how they did it, and they went ahead and they fixed it. Okay, so as far as the pipe going from the system that I already had it
across the street,
all they did is tie it into the new system that they built, that you gave them approval for when they had to, because they had to come back and make the system a little bigger or make some changes. So that part's been done.
I think so. I don't remember that well. I didn't review it before, but
well, no.
Yeah. So that's so that drain pipe was connected.
That drain pipe was connected. Yeah. Right. So after that, nothing else was ever done to any of the other drainage that was already.
Well, I guess the problem I've had is that when I looked at the drainage design and looked at what's out there in the field, they don't match. Even though I heard from Patrick a couple of times that all the drainages been approved and everything is the way it was designed. I don't know, and I've never seen anything that has shown that. We never got anything. The planning board, and this is something I have regrets on now, is that we allowed your engineer to do some of the inspections, and VHB didn't do all the inspections or Graves. Our usual, typically, the way we do it is we have a town engineer or a town hired engineer do the inspections of the construction to make sure things are completed per the design. The way the
they were sharing
where they and the way they shared it, the drainage fell onto Thompson Liston, and we didn't get any documentation that everything was built in accordance with the design. At least not that I can remember.
As far as I can remember, they were done. They were done, and VHB was copied on them.
Well, but it's,
I think so, but
That's what I'm looking, I mean, we're talking 5 years ago or 6 years ago, so yeah. I may be fuzzy on it, but what I remember is looking at the plans, and the thing that just jumps at me is that I see on the plans that you've got two rain gardens proposed.
And the two rain gardens are done. Listen, here's what happened. The rain gardens were done. They were functioning fine. The only thing that happened to the one big rain garden, it eroded. In other words, there was the rain garden was built like this originally, and it was complete. Okay, it was built like this with a little pool in the middle. Okay, the big one. Over the time, it ended up getting rounded. So, which meant that the water, when it rained, didn't pool in that little crevice and slowly go down the side. Which, you know what, it still worked, because the bottom line is, you get a torrential downpour, it's gonna flow right over the side anyway, but, right? It's not gonna stay in that little.
No, that's not the purpose of a rain garden. I would like to have an engineer tell me that what was built functioning as a rain garden. It's approved by DEP.
It was.
I want an engineer to tell me that.
Okay. I'm an engineer, and I'll tell you first. At a time, it was operational, and then the construction, the snow pile plowing, the whatever, have undone.
Well, if I could see pictures of something that actually was done and done correctly, because the pictures that I have, actually, I don't even have them here. From years ago, I was driving through, because I don't get there as often as I should, but I do get into that mall a few times.
I think you went by some pictures. I saw.
Did you?
I think so.
Yeah, I don't think that was.
No, that's the model village. No, they're not taking off. Well, I think it was 2012 or so. I had, you can see that the rain gardens, it does not go down. There's a catch basin right next to the rain garden.
And one of them? I'm not sure which one.
As you drive in, it was this one on the left.
So the bigger one?
Yep, well, yes. And there's supposedly a volume of storage that was designed to be taken, whether it's a water quality volume or what, I'm not sure of, because I don't remember it that well, but usually when you design a rain garden, there's some kind of 2012. There's usually some kind of way for the water to get into the rain garden. A rain garden, as opposed to an island in the middle of the park, an island has the curbing around it, and island goes
right
up.
Well, you can see
a rain garden, it goes down.
Right, and you can see this one don't have the curbing around this section.
Yeah, but it doesn't go down. You can have no curbing, but and that's why there is no curbing, because it was supposed to have no curbing
and go down.
Go down,
right.
So the water could go in.
Right, and there is no curbing.
There, okay, that part you got right. I'll give you that.
Well, that's
but the mound in the middle doesn't. That's where you're supposed to store this water quality volume.
Well, the mound was there, though. You're right, and that was 80%. I'm just going off my.
If you can submit something to show that it's been built.
Just going off my head, I'd say that mound, and I'm just going off my head. Huh? This was a long time ago, and I'm not a thing. If I remember correctly, like the mixture there was like some crazy thing, 80% sand and X amount of dirt. I mean, whatever, to make it the right mixture for it to absorb the water.
Yes.
And I know that was done. I know it was.
That's possible. Yeah, it could be almost all done. And they may just need to go out.
It's got to be, it's got to be all done over.
But that would be part of some amended site plan or a new site plan.
But
right now, the board decided that the site plan is null and void. So you're now operating without an approved site plan review.
Well,
on the whole plaza, on what?
On whatever's left on that south portion.
I think that came from some.
Copy? I don't have a copy of the Cumberland Farms approval.
It's right there. I mean,
okay, you want to read the whatever the item is that was the.
The drainage one.
The one that talked about the southern portion not being approved site plan review.
It's item nine. Item 9, it says the approved stormwater treatment system is designed only for the leased area north of the entrance driveway. Therefore, a new site plan review for the area south of the entrance driveway is needed prior to creation of any impervious surface or issuance of a building permit in this area of the property. The work associated with the previous approved site plan review is not completed. was not completed.
Okay, but instead of that, in other words, that now is null and void because Cumberland came to you.
This is the Cumberland letter.
I understand, but that's null and void because Cumberland came to you after that and readdressed my drainage issue, which you gave them permission
so
to expand.
So where did the site plan review approval from the planning board come from? Did you get a new one after that one came out? It's coming from the planning board saying there is a site plan approval. Right now, that one says there is none anymore.
Well, I can sure.
You're saying they addressed it.
They, yeah, well, well.
But the issue is there is none.
It's a site plan review.
The issue is there is none? They talked, wait a minute, hang on a second. Let me just do this, because I, as far as I knew, there was, and as far as I knew, they got one, well, I know they got one also from DCF, because they had to change it also. They had to address it with them.
Yep.
Okay. I think that was what my phone answered. Let's see what I can find here.
Mark, that is addressing the Cumberland site when you were in condition 9.
Yeah, it's the stormwater treatment system under Cumberland Farms.
The one that's going to be there that's now moved.
I think this is saying that Cumberland Farms did their drainage analysis.
They did their in front of their building somewhere.
Somewhere underneath their property, yeah. And it just says that
the
because...
The approval of this one is not, needs to be addressed in the future sometime.
Yeah, it needs to be completed.
So see, here was an email. I had a conference call with them on March 29th to discuss the drainage system in West Boylston. We discussed it. Now I got to go find the ones after that where they went to you guys. They said that, here's what they said actually, and if my memory serves me correctly, they didn't think they were going to need to come to you and have a full meeting. They thought they could just come to you and tell you about it and you would get it approved, or you would approve it. And that's what they, I think they said happened.
Well,
all right, I'm not 100% certain.
I don't think
that.
This is really at all about the stub pipe or anything. I
think that is about that.
Of the condition? I didn't think we were well, we knew about that at that point.
Right, the stub pipe came in after, I think, because what's the date on our approval?
It was February 10th.
Yeah, February 10th.
Yeah, it was right after. This was March that they came back to you. I don't know, does anybody remember?
For some reason, I think that there was a little bit of confusion when they were coming in talking about your site plan whole project, but only ever talking about their corner. And so we said, how do you want to handle this? And they said, well, we only want to do our part in our corner. And yeah, I think that's where that came
that's
from.
That's where that came from. But then in the end, I said, listen, you were wrong doing that. You had no right to do that.
Right.
In other words,
I know, I agree with you. That I have no problem with. The trouble was they were representing you to us, and so we.
Well, they weren't representing me. They were representing that portion of
the lease portion. Right.
Right. In other words,
what they were doing was we had a site plan review on the property for the liquor store and this front lot at the same time. That's what the old site plan review was for.
Actually, the old site plan, we didn't know what was going to be there at that point.
Right, right.
Well, we were talking liquor store.
It was the liquor store.
No, the liquor store came after. When we got the site, the liquor store was 2012. The approval was 2000.
It was a retail use.
It was a retail use.
Okay.
Oh, and then we revised it. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Oh, I guess there's a couple of
yeah. Yeah, so.
And then they moved down the road.
Yeah, so that's a whole nother story. We don't need to talk about that story. Okay. But the bottom line is Cumberland was wrong. I told Cumberland they were wrong. They told me they were going to address it. They told me they did address it. I know that they did make their system bigger.
Yes, that part. Yeah, they came in and they did that, but they didn't clearly say that this was to have the site plan approval
apply
to yours. So it's never been applied to yours.
Well,
so that's
where it is. It's already tied in.
Well, it's under construction, which is the hard part. Even though we had talked to the building inspector and said there's no site plan review, you had convinced him that there was.
I didn't. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
I'm not saying you lied. You said what you believe to be the truth, and he said, okay.
All I said, and if you go back and you think about, all I said to the building inspector was, we fall under the permit extension plan.
Right.
And I showed him, and I showed him an email that Patrick sent me that he had a conversation with you.
Yeah.
And you said, you're sorry, Patrick, you're right. I forgot about the permit extension plan. So that's all I said to the building inspector.
Right.
I didn't mean
well, to make anything more. I didn't, but you convinced him with what you said, whatever it was.
I convinced him. No, I gave him that I'm under a permit extension. That's it. I didn't.
Okay.
What do you think I did? Beat him in the head with a
knife? No, he's just saying based on your...
I agree with what you're saying.
Based on the conversation that you had with him, the inspector was under the opinion that everything was okay.
And I was under the... You,
right.
Exactly. Well, let's put it this way. I went to him with the idea that everything was okay. I didn't portray anything other than what I thought, okay?
Yeah.
So...
Yeah.
If you're trying to say something other than that, he was trying to say what I said.
I didn't mean to intimate that.
I presented what I thought to be the truth,
yeah,
and nothing but the truth.
Right. And I agree.
So then we get to the, all right, so the pipe is all set. It's fine.
Right.
I mean, how it ended up getting the way it got, I mean, again, I don't want to go backwards and start pointing fingers.
Right.
They're a tenant of mine. I'm happy to have them there. But at the same time, I wasn't happy when this happened. Okay.
They undid done stuff.
Well, yeah. And,
yes.
You know, so.
And then fixed it.
And then tried to fix it. But you say they didn't really fix it the right way, really.
Well, I think they did that part. But there's other parts. There's a remainder that still needs to be done, is what I've said.
Well, the only things that really are left, okay, I mean, we know about refixing the rain gardens. I knew about that from your conversation with Patrick at the permit extension point, you know what I mean, when he told you about that. I knew about that since then, but my plan was, when I'm doing all of this, I got to fix all the berms over there.
Well, yeah, you're doing some other work with some other islands that are going in. That was part of
That's Cumberland.
Oh, that is? I thought that's beyond the lease area, though.
Yeah, because what happened was when they went to DCR, these are all last-minute things that happened. When they went to DCR, DCR said, look, you got to get more water into the ground. They said, we've got no more land to get water into the ground. So now they come to me and they say, hey, Andy, we got to get more water into the ground. I said, okay. I want him as a tenant. I want them for the town, I want them for myself, I want them, of course, do whatever you gotta do. That's why those things are there. I mean, they're horrible, I mean, really, I mean, they're gonna make it harder to plow, but look, if that's what you need to get it done, I said, go ahead, do it. I mean.
So that mix-up is theirs.
Yeah, that was.
Okay, well, I don't.
That has nothing to do with me.
That's okay.
Except me letting them to do it.
I mean, and I work there, but I don't do that portion of the work. So.
Yeah, that came in later. I don't.
Yeah.
And I just said, go ahead, do it.
Right.
So, but I didn't do that work. So.
So what we might need then is the site
some
plan.
Some site plan amendment or something.
Right.
So, I mean, just showing that work.
You that know, work?
Well, whatever work happened that changed.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not on the other.
I think they have something showing that.
They should be.
They probably.
But, yeah, no, they do because they had to submit it to.
But if they can't. I mean, we were under the impression that they were only ever talking about their corner of the property. If they extend past it.
Well, that's what they tried. That's where it started, okay? But then it became expanded. Next thing you know, they needed more parking spots. Again, I say, don't listen, I don't care. We got an extra 150 of them. Take whatever you need. I want to do whatever needs to be done. That was my theory through the whole thing. But at the same time, I'm letting you do whatever you need to do to get this done. Don't.
But we don't control their permitting, their work, what they have to do. Their permit says they can do or not do. That was all on their own.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, unfortunately.
Yeah, well, they did that. They did what they're supposed to do. I mean, they came to us with everything. And whatever, and then some.
Yeah.
But I mean, at some point we have to tie all this together and say, this is the way the whole property site plan is working out, not just this corner, and not just this corner in dribs and drabs, or across the street.
I agree. I mean, we can, but basically on my side, nothing has changed except for that pipe. Not one thing has changed except for that pipe.
As long as they put that pipe back together, then nothing has changed again.
They did, but that's now on their side.
That's what I mean. Then it's okay. As long as the system is, as on your side, was the way it was supposed to be and designed and everything,
that part
put back together.
We never touched one thing on our side. Whatever was done back in 2009 and 10 is still exactly the same way. The only difference is this is no longer tied into what I had it tied into. It's now tied into the system that they built.
And that change would have been reflected with the updated plan.
On their plan.
It should be on their updated plan.
Because it used to, I'm just going by memory, I think that it came out and it went all the way around, it came all the way around through their property.
It was on the side of their property. And see where they were putting their building.
Route 12, Main Road, it was over there.
That was the system I did.
That was the one he put in before that they then put over here.
Okay, and then across the street is where the new stuff is?
No, this is still all here.
This is the one that Andy's talking about that hasn't changed at all.
See this pipe right here?
Yeah, that was the pipe.
That was the pipe. This pipe now goes over here.
Right, and eventually drains back around over and overflows over into the...
Into the other thing. But as far as... We didn't change one thing over here. None of this got changed.
Right, it comes in and goes out.
They extended that over here.
Changed this angle on their site plan.
Did they reuse that piece of equipment?
No,
they put a new.
They ripped it all up.
Yeah, because the tank is somewhere in there.
It's in the middle. Threw away money and spent more money.
Yeah.
There you go.
No, they ripped that all up. Yeah. Threw every bit of it away and saved one thing from it. Not one.
Terrific.
So, but their building was going to sit on top of it, so they couldn't put it there. And they didn't want to move the building. They didn't want to change. You know, there were certain things that they just didn't want to do. So, but that's fine. But my pipe is tied in. But as far as anything else over here, the only issue now really is the parking layout. Because when they were, it was always the plan. If you go back into the 2009 minutes or whatever, at that point, throughout, it was said, whatever's going to be here, the entrance is going to be directly opposite, so the businesses can do this.
That's the original.
That was the original thing. That was
what
we wanted.
There
were aligned driveways. So then what happened is, because they were thinking in the terms of, well, we're only thinking about
us, right?
Us.
So they come in with a plan. And they change the islands out of here.
Yes.
On there.
So in the end,
without approval,
that hurt.
Oh, well, I mean, at some point, changing that stuff that was, you said do what you got to do, and so they did what they got to do.
But I said do what you got to do, as long as it don't affect me.
Well, okay.
Okay. So it did affect me in the end. I mean, but I didn't think the effect. Here's what happened. When I found out about that effect, I said to Patrick, look, can we still get 12 parking spaces there? He laid it out and said, we can still get 12 parking spaces there. I said, well, then I guess it isn't that detrimental, Oh, yeah. So that's kind of where we were at in the end. You know, as far as anything else, the building got smaller. By 150 square feet, it didn't get bigger,
Okay, these are the same things.
These are the same things you've been seeing back and forth. These are just full size, if you will.
So,
and it shows you the two different situations, but.
Right, aligned and then misaligned.
And you can see, I highlighted it. I highlighted on these.
The problem with the original plan now is it's going to be, we all know how people drive, right?
There's a driving school right there, for goodness sake.
I know. Look, let's be honest about it, right? If somebody can take a shortcut, they're going to take a shortcut. Mm-hmm. And not having the driveways aligned is going to make someone come to here who says...
Zoom across.
They can't zoom across.
Zoom negatively.
They're going to zoom diagonally and come in. If they say, you know what, I want a yogurt, there's no cars coming, they're going to be doing this constantly. And then, and if they weren't, and if they didn't, instead still said they wanted to come here, right? They're going to have to come down here and make a U-turn, which you're making a U-turn into a lot of traffic coming this way. So this plan now should have no, this is not a good plan. And anybody who says it is mistaken, because this is a very dangerous plan, because people, by nature, look for the shortcut. And you know, it's very dangerous. You know that's going to happen. You know that people are going to do that. Having the driveways aligned, it may not be the perfect scenario with these two parking spots up here, okay?
Or the two on the other side of the road.
Well, it's all these ones sort of here that where people are going to be zooming by. They might not be looking far enough to see this guy backing out.
Well, right. So you know, that's not the perfect scenario there. But, you know, maybe with some signage in front of these cars saying, look, before you back out.
You can't leave until 7.
Well, no. Before you back out, you make sure nobody's behind you or something. You know, maybe with some help of some signage, no matter how you shake it, this is the better plan, because then nobody's going to be... cheating. They're going to try and they. You know, people are going to do that. Kids are definitely going to do it. They're going to pull in for gas here. They're going to say, "Oh, I want an ice cream."
Oh, you think they're going to go all the way across?
Yeah.
They can get everything they want.
Cumberland Farms sells ice cream.
Yeah, but they don't sell.
Fancy stuff.
Yeah.
The better stuff.
But so yeah. That's or if they did it the right way, right?
Straight across.
No. No, if we stuck with the other plan, I'm saying. Or if they said, well, okay, I can't go straight across because it's at an angle. I got to take a left, a right. I'm going to come down to the end of here, and I'm going to whip a U-ey. That's what's going to happen to get in here if you don't have the driveways aligned.
Maybe you should put a rotary in.
Not a bad idea.
Maybe Cumberland should have paid for the rotary.
But so that's the situation. This is more dangerous. This plan, having this like this and this like this, is more dangerous to the cars that are coming in and out of here than having the driveways aligned.
What our engineer said.
He's concerned. Yeah, well, his big concern was these two parking spots.
Yeah. Well, why can't you?
But you'll notice they have the same two parking space situation.
They have the same two parking spaces here, backing into the drive. There's no difference.
Except the entering vehicles are the far away side.
Right, right.
You know, not the people coming here will see them.
They're coming up to a stop, so people are going slower and stopping. Hopefully,
and they're zooming in on this side.
Yeah,
but I guess in your parking layout, what's the square that's next to the...
That's the problem. We can't, because of...
Why can't we get remove that?
We tried. That's Verizon. They have an easement. It would take...
What are you talking about?
An act of Congress in years and $20,000.
Where's the property line on this drawing?
Property line that matters is this sort of square that you see in the entrance.
That crosses the spaces.
That crosses the... parking spaces.
Yeah,
how does that work?
It's more of a mass DOT restriction line.
No, it's a property line, isn't it?
No. That's an easement.
No, it's a property line.
No, it's not. It's an easement. Look, they wouldn't never let me put a sign there.
You got a special letter from them saying it was allowed to be put on your
on my property.
No, to be put on the state property. I thought there was.
No, they wouldn't do that. No, if it was state-owned property, they wouldn't do that. You couldn't pay them to do it. That's what they thought first when we were talking to them, until they looked at the language in the agreement, in the documents, and then they found out, you're right, it's only an easement.
So
So, okay, so that solves a lot of the problems I had, so.
Yeah.
But it screws up the signage, this sign. Because we were saying
you haven't seen a sign on this.
Well, no, it's a different kind of document.
Well, because we said you can't have another sign, you already have a standing sign on the property. And they said, well, that's not on the property, that's on the state property.
Oh, no,
that's sort of a weird answer.
No, that's an easement.
That was the self-serving answer.
That is, I will tell you the truth, the state did say that first until we had to show them that isn't what the language said.
Well, but that's what Cumberland Farms came in here saying that sign is on the state right-of-way. Or on the, yeah, within the state right-of-way, so their sign is not two signs.
Again, I.
There's a problem in language of the state with right-of-way versus ownership line. And right-of-way to the state isn't necessarily the same thing as a Vinnie Vignali lot right-of-way allowing you to go somewhere.
Well,
so the right-of-way line is the line of the highway, the way you would be able to build the highway, as opposed to a right-of-way, which is an easement. There are differences the way the state looks at right-of-way.
So then when Cumberland Farms came in here, they weren't telling us the whole truth, that there are now two standing signs on this one property.
We were hoping it was the state property.
No, I mean, we were point blank told that it was not.
I don't know
what they... I mean, that's what I'm basing it on. It's not... I haven't looked at the survey documents, or I haven't gone
to
the
RIVs. Look, at DOT would have never let me put the sign there, because at first they did think that's what they had. And then we had to show them that ain't what they had, and they said,
There's signs in there right away up and down this road.
Yeah, that's not...
I mean,
they were gonna... If that was in their thing, they weren't gonna let me do it.
Yeah, they won't give the permit.
Give the permit.
They won't get rid of them when they're there.
Yeah, maybe that's the case. But they were not going to give me one if that was the case, okay?
But their sign isn't in the right-of-way.
No, but it's the second standing sign on the property.
Okay.
But I think
that was the thing.
But honestly, I think in that bylaw, and I'm just...
We get to waive strict compliance.
I thought there was something that said if you could have two standing signs on a property, if it's a, it had to do with, I thought the bill at the time, Chris Long had said it.
One for a lot is what it says. One for a lot, so it's...
Yeah, it's one for a lot, and the business center gets...
Okay, well, I didn't come here and profess that.
I don't want to go there.
I didn't do that. I didn't say anything. This is what I mean. I think it got really kind of... What am I going to say? I want to say it nicely. Messed up a little bit, maybe.
Nothing's that wrong. I mean, there's no...
Well, I got promised a lot of things that weren't true. So,
but I mean, like the...
But I work
on the drawings, and all the drawings are there and exist. There are some details to work out, I think, and we're close.
You know? In the end, everything's going to look good.
I mean, look, we're going to finally finish that front. It's going to look gorgeous up there. I mean, but this parking situation... Not only is it dangerous, and it's dangerous and it's detrimental to the businesses that are going to be here, okay? Because everybody depends on everybody else to survive. And it's advantageous, of course, for me to have everyone survive, but it's also advantageous,
to the survivors.
To them, but also the town. You know what I mean? Look, you don't want things starting and closing and stopping, and
right?
I mean, the idea here is we got to make this business friendly.
Right.
And to make it business friendly, we got to make access to every part of this plaza easy for everybody.
What's the possibility of, I'm just looking at the plan that does not have the conflict with the people parking, and you're saying people are going to come up as they enter the throat there. They're gonna try to shoot across.
Right.
Right now the curb is right there. What if we bring that curb further down? How many people are coming out here? You could almost bring it to a little bit into this aisle here, because
that's the exit.
No, everybody's gonna be taking a left.
Yeah, but bring it down even further. That green line, bring it. So it inhibits.
No, you're gonna have them yelling at you.
No. Everybody's going to want to take a left.
You still get out of Cumberland Farms. No one's coming in on that side.
No, but people
get gas after school.
Yeah, but you can make the turn. They're turning into the inside, not the...
So you're making a proposal there to make that
Even tighter.
Even tighter, yes. But instead of worrying about because of these two parking spots?
Yeah, because that's where things are going to, I mean, we've got troubles with, what's the other guy? That
well, then here, how's this?
Dairy Queen. I mean, not Dairy Queen.
How's this?
Yeah, Dairy Queen. That's my biggest problem because of...
We don't have a drive-through though.
No, you don't have a drive-through,
no,
but you've got
just
people
traffic.
Coming in.
Yeah,
it's a traffic mess. And
right.
We don't want to have that.
But you're going to have... Vinny, look, there's 12 spots here. There ain't 50 spots here. There ain't going to be traffic going crazy here.
How many spots over at Dairy Queen, do you remember?
At Dairy Queen?
Yeah, 14?
Yeah, something like that.
But that wasn't big enough. You should.
Well, that's what I'm afraid of here.
We hope this is as popular as Dairy Queen.
That's different. You know, Dairy Queen has the drive-thru. They're selling hamburgers, they're selling things. So the drive-thru is what messes up Dairy Queen. Mm. The drive-thru is backed up out onto the street. It's not the cars that are parked in the 14 spots. It's the drive-thru that's messing it up. I mean,
give you some of that, right?
Well, that's the truth. I mean, you got to look at these things realistically. Look, the flip side of the coin is we could say, well, okay, nix the two parking spots. Well, then I'm shot two parking spots.
Yeah,
okay, we'll tell them we got two parking spots in the, I got 140 extra ones. I mean, you want us to get rid of the two? We can get rid of the two.
Oh, employees park over in the other area.
Anyway, we're going to do that anyway. No, that's going to happen anyway. Employees are going to park in the main lot anyway.
So what's the required parking for the
2900? Well, it's 2,780 square feet. It comes to 11.16. So we're at 12. So, I mean,
some of the stuff is,
you know, the flip side of the coin is if you want to say, look, go with 10 and have two out there and nix those two, fine. It don't matter. We got extra parking spots.
Has the fire chief looked at this?
Well, I assumed. Well, I don't know. I assume so because the building inspector gives it to the fire chief.
I don't know.
I think it was.
I mean, I wouldn't assume that, so I would hesitate on any of this until we hear back from the fire chief.
What about the police?
Maybe because
and police,
that's a sidewalk with a handicap.
Fire, he's got the big truck.
That's a whole lot, so.
True, but I would also think that.
Well, when if we were to go the other way?
Fire department got to have access
to
three sides.
Back to the original spot.
And they'll have it.
And put a stomp line or something.
Yeah, they'll have it here.
Hmm. Well, somebody could mess around.
Yeah, and you may be right.
Well, I know that the building inspector gives it to the fire chief. So, honestly, that's a building inspector question, really, because the building inspector gives it to them. Just like I just gave
them. No, it's a site plan review question.
Well, no. I gave them a... look, the building inspector definitely gives it to the fire department. He asked me for three plans, and one of them's for the fire department.
Okay.
So I know he saw it. He must have approved it before he gave me the permit.
Then it should be easy.
Yeah, it should be. Then send it to him. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Or ask the building inspector if he gave it to the fire department. Right?
Yeah.
I know he did. So just like I just presented him a build-out plan, he says it's going to take a few days because I got to have the fire department look at it.
I don't know. So usually when we do a site plan review, we get a letter back from the fire department saying we need a fire lane, we need this, everything looks great, whatever it might be. We get some feedback whenever there's
a matter of course.
I understand that, but here's the whole problem with the whole thing. I didn't know we were doing a site plan review. And that starts with the pipe. You know what I mean? In other words...
Well, they saw that. They saw the Cumberland Farms one, because they had to talk about a bunch of things.
Right.
You know, I mean, the fire department talked about that one.
I assume they did.
Yeah. I mean, they did. I know they saw that one. But I don't think they knew about it. They paid attention over here, because nothing was going on.
No, but at one point...
I think they should have.
Well, but there's not even any construction over
there. See, and I think part of the problem might have been, too... Maybe having two different engineering
drawings.
I know you couldn't use them or something, or you didn't want them.
Yeah, it'd been done.
But maybe
years.
There was no, like.
They should have been.
Not there. Normally we have one that does it all. And
so, you know, maybe that's part of the situation. Again, I don't want to be pointing fingers at anybody, and I don't want any pointed at me. I think it is what it is.
Yep.
We're at the point we're at.
The next step is to have people that need to give feedback on it to give the feedback. And if you're, I mean, the way I look at it, I think you don't have a site plan review approval on this, and we could do it and have a site plan. You could do a request an amended site plan review, and we can make that happen. Because I think we're basically doing that right now. But we need something to happen. And that's your call. I don't know.
Well, I don't know what it is we need to happen except for the parking. There's no drainage issue.
Except that you're finishing.
Huh?
You're finishing the project up.
Right. But the question is, where does he build his driveway?
This is the only issue. In other words, that's going to be the last thing I'm going to finish, but that's the issue. There's no other issues. When Wayne looked at everything that we presented him,
yep.
He only came back with
this.
Well, this is the rain garden after, but so.
And that seems like it's easy enough to fix. If it was all built, all you have to do is.
We're going to, exactly. And that was the plan anyway, so it wasn't like I didn't know it. I was doing it, so.
We didn't know it.
What we're trying to figure out is, where is he going to build his driveway if Cumby did not pay attention to the prior approval and moved the driveway to where they wanted it rather than where it originally had been planned to be opposite this one? What do we do now?
You go for another site plan review?
Well, it should be only limited to the parking. There's nothing else.
That's what you asked.
Well, yeah, but yeah, bring in the whole drawing. You bring in the whole
existing garage. In other words, we can't go back and start talking about the size of the building,
No. And I don't think.
Request an amended site plan approval of the changes to the parking.
An amended site plan review.
This is
the amendment is this.
Well, the parking.
Right.
Well, I mean, you can put everything in, whatever happened here. The building got a little smaller, so that'll be okay.
Do we put that on there? I mean,
if you do it now.
Change, but, I mean, that you're down by 100 square feet. We don't get that detail. We're not that worried about it.
No, but I mean, that
as long
if
as
you
have
do
the,
it on the drawing,
the
it'll be the as-built drawing, too.
Are the right size, I assume, so
yeah.
We should be okay. It's just you need a site plan review, supposedly, before you get the building permit.
Well, can't we make that review right? I mean, we're sitting here talking about the one issue that's here. In other words, how can't we kind of come to some sort, I mean, and then we come back again and like, you want to do some formal thing, I don't know. But, I mean, we're talking about one issue that.
Vinny, what do you think about if we pulled the island back to the original location of the island and put like a stop line or something like that so that people couldn't come, you could S through the intersection? I mean, it's sort of a screwy thing. It's like, it's sort of a Kelly
Wide
Square kind of thing.
Instead of an arrow.
Yeah. It's like a Kelly Square kind of intersection.
Oh, don't compare it to Kelly Square.
But better.
Doesn't sound good.
Kelly Square, but better.
Well, I'm not, which way
where I took my kids to learn how to drive.
A lot less traffic.
Right.
Oh, jeez.
Like, use this one where they're misaligned, but then take the island back to the original location that lines up with here. So that
so
these
you have
people
a big
could leave.
Wide open space?
Yeah.
Yeah. But at least then you won't have people chicaning around.
You wouldn't.
Islands
you go go crooked.
And,
you'd take a left and then take a quick
traffic.
Right.
That's
a right and quick left.
It's an option to let people who do traffic look at. Yeah.
I don't know if that's any safer, but I think the rotary is a good idea.
Is that a city or a parking truck?
That's an in between. That we didn't talk about.
Well, because then there's
but
not
at least
a.
Then we have the abilities.
And you can put a stop sign or something like that, because there's already. It looks like there's a crosswalk there.
Yeah, there is.
Because there's.
Well, there was. There was. I don't know.
Yeah, where's the tie-in? Is that tying into something on?
Andy.
Well, there is a crosswalk on this side. It looks.
And we had. And we have a sidewalk. Yeah.
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 So there's a crosswalk there, but where does it go? I mean, there may be one there. I don't know.
They have one.
Well, some of that came from the plan we had before Cumby took over and did.
So that's the question.
That's kind of what we want to see is where the sidewalk is tying in. And I would really like to see a sidewalk continue on Route 12.
But there's no way we can because it's this, Vinny.
It's
up on the guardrail. No, it's up.
That's something we want. I would like to see.
Well, Vinny, that ain't happening.
Yeah.
We talked about it. That ain't happening. The land goes like this. Okay, up on, I mean, what? You want me building walls to put up a sidewalk? They're going to fall off the wall.
A skyway over the road.
The land goes like that.
I don't have a
well,
contours. I drove by, I looked at it, there's a guardrail that could be removed now because it doesn't drop off anymore.
No, it's not.
No, it doesn't. Right next to your building, it doesn't drop off.
Yes, it does. What are you talking about? It goes like this.
Between your building and the roadway, there's a hole there?
Well, no, it's like this. And then it goes like this. There's about 10 feet.
Leave that to you, go back and look at it.
Go back and look at it. You'll see it goes like this. Okay, from the guardrail to where it levels out, it's about like that. Okay.
So it's like 4 feet and how wide? Why, like 15 feet?
No, the whole length of... Well, then furthermore, we could never do it... Where were you going to start the sidewalk? It's all... In other words, Here's the property. This is all... We can't build it back any further than probably here. So you're going to have a sidewalk that's this long. Because you can't start it here, because this is all...
Dropping off
into the wetlands.
It's possible. Sidewalk would be nice. I don't know what...
This would be the sidewalk. This would be the sidewalk to nowhere.
We got a sidewalk on Cumberland Farms.
Yeah,
We have a sidewalk that comes to here.
Yeah.
So that anything coming this way could go to Cumberland's. Yeah. Anything coming from Cumberland's can come into here. So there's a sidewalk there, but putting one here is an impossibility. Unless you want to pay for it. I mean...
Did the Cumby sidewalk go back into the plaza as well?
Yes, it does. It does, yeah.
So it probably goes hook up.
So it probably goes over to there.
Yeah.
It would hook up, but I don't think there's a break, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it does. It goes...
Oh, yeah, I mean, it keeps going all the way along, but there'd have to be like a... I think there's lawn along the edge of it. I don't remember. I know there's lawn up here. I don't know where down here.
I can't think, actually, looking at it. But I just know that the front, that's an impossibility. I mean, first of all, if you could start it at Chase's property and bring it all the way across, that's one thing. Then you have a sidewalk.
Then you could use the bus stop.
We're stuck at the point now where we're trying to do it piecemeal, so whenever someone comes in on Route 12, we try to get a sidewalk on their frontage.
Well, we know what you try to do, but it's like you're never going to get it here because there's no way they could ever match up, ever.
Well,
it's impossible.
Just show me, that's all I need.
Go. You're a smart guy. You're not blind. You're going to go there and you're going to see that you can't.
It's not true, but that's all right.
Well, maybe you are, I don't know. But where the wall stops, there's about a 6-foot drop to the wetlands. And then...
And you may be right, I have not been there, so...
Yeah, well, it is. We had looked at this subject 5 years ago when you said it. About the same
thing. And it's still not in?
I'm consistent. Right?
You are. You ask for the same things. I don't know if you televise those. If you have tapes on those, you can go back and we had the same conversation.
I don't think we have tapes.
We had the same exact conversation.
Could be true.
No, it's true. So this is where we're at. We got these two options. And
I think we're going to ask BHB or somebody's traffic engineers how to make this intersection work like this with the safe parking and not have people zooming across with doing weird things.
You're going to ask the same traffic engineers who designed this without paying attention to the driver?
Well, they didn't pay attention to there. They just looked in here. No, I think they were just looking at parking.
So,
but we could ask there. You to get it all for not our cost, you could ask their engineers. Bowler?
I mean,
it's the Bowler guys.
Yeah.
They might do it, I don't know. But then they get, we put it on their whatever ticket.
I honestly, when I look at these two parking spaces look a lot safer backing into a wider drive that we have here than the narrower drive backing into these spaces. And then you got these two were approved by VHB and you guys 4 years ago. But when you look at this, this is a wider aisle here. Okay, right here. When you look at this, so these two cars have enough room to back out. When you look at this, we got two spots here that are going to back out into a narrower drive. I mean, I really, you're looking at...
I don't know why they... didn't address, didn't make that wider there, like have this curve.
Well, they couldn't.
Because of the curve.
Yeah, they couldn't. But I'm saying that was an approved plan, and that's the one he says he likes better. But how is that better when you're backing these two spots into a wider drive?
Oh, I think that his whole thing is that cars are going to be coming in, not that don't see the whole situation. They're coming fast.
But they're going to do the same here. They're not going to see the situation with these cars backing out.
They have more time after they get in the driveway to pay attention, and yeah. They're turning.
They're on the exiting side. The ones on the old plan are on the exiting side. So the traffic is typically paying more attention.
Well, that's
not on the inside. These guys are coming in and they're not looking at parking.
Okay.
So which cars are you saying that about? The ones cutting across and the ones coming off?
I know, but.
No, anyone coming in here.
No, but it's got to be one of the, in other words, either we're talking about the cars that are cutting across from Cumberland or whatever it's going to be there at the time. Are those the ones you're saying can't see? Those should have clear vision.
No, it's not. It's the fact that the parking spaces on the one you want are on the entrance side.
I understand that, but.
And the ones that are working there are on the exit.
But when they're leaving Cumberland Farms, when you're leaving Cumberland Farms, you're right here. You're right here.
Yeah,
come on now. You're stopped in this middle. You're not going to see these two cars backing up. Come on.
It's not where they're coming from. You're backing into.
Well, it is where they're coming from because you need them to have the visual.
Well,
let
traffic engineers talk about it. They'll figure it out. It has more sense.
And when they come up here, if we have a stop sign here, right? So when you come up here, if there's a stop sign here to take a right in, that's going to stop people.
Oh, slow down everything.
And just to give you a heads up, when you're looking at the cemented site plan, I looked at it and I had a couple of questions on where is the trash container?
On the new one, we had said because we're going to do it. We're going to take that. We have a pump, a dumpster in the backside. We're going to use it for this property. It's tied up there, so we're going to use that.
It sounded like it said you were going to do it.
I am.
The owner will do it every day. I'm
But we have someone. We do have someone picking up the trash every day. So we'll just incorporate those two. They're small stores. They're not going to generate.
Is that tons. What's? And is that what's over by the handicap space?
No, there is no trash.
There is no trash.
What's that gate at the handicap space?
Where are you?
That's the eject panel.
In the lower right, Vinny, there's a -2 and -3. Which plan are you
looking at? Which plan?
On the front plan.
Actually, it's on both of them.
The first one?
2 does show a trash.
Trash, yeah. 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 Which, when you're really.
Oh, that's a trash container.
Through the
trash container.
And what's this hatched area? Just the opening, the door opening,
the
opening?
But that's the one VHB says he likes.
Well, he likes the traffic layout.
Well, again, there's no such thing as a perfect plan. We got to get to the plan that makes the most sense.
Yep. I was going for perfect.
Well. I know I'm perfect, and I try to be.
He's laughing at you.
Yeah. Raise the chair.
Oh.
But honestly, I see these two spots being not a big issue. You're making them bigger than they really need to be. I think we've addressed it really well, the parking. I mean.
Maybe you put instead of a handicap chair, you put like a pirate's, skull and crossbones, because those are dangerous.
Okay.
All right, so.
Where are we going from here?
Yeah.
The amended parking plan.
Well, we have
Chris,
to somebody.
Chris has the floor.
Okay, go.
Amended site plan, as we had talked about, as to the parking.
So we submit what we want to do?
Well,
no.
Well,
then we talk and it may go back and forth a couple of times.
For me, it would be helpful to hear, any fire department feedback,
police.
Maybe engage Wayne at VHB a little bit more to suggest some of the things that you're talking about and see if he said, I didn't think of that. Maybe that, makes more sense.
Shall we stay with just these two sketches, maybe colored, maybe cleaned up or some fashion, and a cover letter that says, please amend whatever approvals are affecting this parcel relative to the driveway parking arrangement, or?
Or should we also look at 10 spots in this space? And then you get rid of those two, and?
There, those options are there. When you say pick one, the one you want, it may be easier to contact VHB, review with them before you prepare a final plan, review their issues. If they agree to one of them, then we move forward that one. We don't have to worry about all the other stuff. They're the engineer. If the fire chief, police chief, and VHB are happy with the layout, then we'll be happy. That's, I mean, that's our safety group, so.
If you don't get unanimity on Wayne, fire, police, whatever else, you guys are gonna have to make a decision.
Yes.
No. So we're aiming for them to.
Do you have opinions as to two or three on the sketches, or some?
Well, given what we know as we sit here today, I'm inclined to go along with what our engineer is telling us. I mean, I haven't heard anything from fire, haven't heard anything police, but of those three, we've heard from one, and he's saying there's an issue here with the plan where the driveways are aligned.
Do you have a vehicle, paperwork vehicle, for getting opinions of town staff at this stage with these?
With these sketches?
SKs.
We just give.
We, well, if we do a site plan, an amended site plan, we send that off, and that's.
The amended site plan would be the mechanism.
Can you just send these off now and get a comment?
We could just ask.
Yeah.
Maybe it's.
We can always talk.
I don't see why not.
Yeah.
Would you please?
Do that.
And on this one.
You still need an amended site plan.
Maybe I should look to my right and say, would you please?
Right.
That's why I'm not looking up.
And showing this, we would say, we would tell them, this one, where's that island? What do you want?
Where would you like, or recommend, or should it be shortened, or?
Or get there.
Leave it where it is?
I don't know. Yeah.
That's where it is. That's where Cummings moved it.
Right. This is the Cumberland version. This is the original.
Right.
I don't know. I don't know which is better, which would smooth the traffic, you know, or make it not, you know.
Which creates fewer dangers?
Well, that's the question.
Maybe a question.
Maybe we should present them also to the fire chief and the police.
Well, I don't wanna have mixed signals here and mixed inputs.
No, I mean, I think the thing for us is, I mean, I'd like to have something in writing from each of them, really.
Just so we feel better.
Saying, you know, what they think. So to the extent who asked the question, I don't know that that's critical. I don't know what the rest of the board feels.
I don't think they're gonna change their opinion based on who asks.
No, I was just thinking, along with them, whether you do it or we do it, we should, you know, kind of bring up our concerns with each one of them. In other words, and then they look at, so whether or not they're thinking in the terms that we're thinking, it's at least brought to their attention. I know you like to think that everyone is gonna look at these and go, oh, wow, this is, but.
It's wonderful.
Yeah, right. I mean, it's.
They're both perfect, and then what are we doing?
And then, right.
All right.
So I.
You may want to do that.
And.
Maybe, or you could do it.
We can do it.
Address that.
But if they had questions, they may want to speak to you.
And the other thing is, you could, whatever, if they say, you know, it would be fine except for this, that's the time to hear about.
Well, when we have the, what is this, and we'll react accordingly. And I think we'll leave it, you should ask for the review that you can get, and we will independently probably.
Visit.
Do the same thing, visit.
Okay.
Do you have these electronic?
We can.
We have them electronic.
I think you already have them.
Oh, that's true, because I came, who made these? Is this you guys? You guys, all right.
Well, what that is the VHB plan superimposed with our stuff, so we didn't make all of the stuff that you see.
But put it together, Cumberland, the Cumberland plans.
Cumberland Farm, sorry, Bowler.
There's too many engineers.
And just to make it even more complicated, the review engineer on that isn't even VHB.
Right.
You know, that's even better.
Graves.
You would get Graves going, too.
Haven't heard anything from Graves. What you asking?
Good. Yeah, we should get that.
Hey, Don, come back.
All right, so I can.
So are we gonna get an amended site plan, a request to get the process for us to do this, the process set up, or?
Do you need more than what we're talking about right now?
Well, it's just the application.
A letter.
You'll write a letter?
Me?
I guess you're writing the letter.
I guess I'm writing the letter. I'm going to give me a...
Well, isn't that the simplest way?
Well, and the application is on the website. I mean, that's kicks it off. It's got the forms, the room for the fire department's opinion and mm-hmm. all that stuff.
Okay.
All right,
thank you.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah. What's their schedule?
On you.
Oh, jeez.
We
should go to the next floor.
Building. Well, there's we're designing the inside of the yogurt.
And there's a big hole in the wall over here. Are you going to have like a window over there?
So windows, yeah.
So that somebody can buy...
No. Window.
Like, oh, just see inside.
Window.
No drive up window, don't you?
No drive up
window. Walk up window or anything. No.
Drive up bicycle.
A bicycle up window?
Oh, a bicycle. That might be a guy. Except it drops up.
Yeah.
Here.
It does. Where'd you hear that?
I saw it.
You know, I'm...
You're going to leave.
Wait a minute. You know what I'm going to make a wide cement...
Concrete
here, as wide as I can. On the
sidewalk-ish.
Well, don't we have an emergency.
Don't put tables there because they need more parking spaces.
But I got the parking spaces. I got all the parking spaces.
So people
spaces.
Park over here and walk all the way up. Okay.
Thank you.
Right?
That's what
it's my in.
It's your in.
No. What am I going to say? No, you can't park there?
No. It's just that the requirements for a seated dining area is more than just a...
We're going to put a few tables inside and three
Come
tables.
Come on, don't tell us this stuff.
Why?
No, it's on his couch. He's got it.
Is that where the 12 spaces comes from?
I don't know.
I don't know how they do the spaces anyway, but whatever. That was the agreed amount of them, 12.
And he knows.
Well, that would be the amended thing.
And anything else we need. Right?
I don't know how they do it. I'll let them do their job.
Okay. But we, whatever. That's the plan.
Okay.
You all say it?
Yeah.
All right. Thank you.
Who gets the planning board email?
Well, it goes to the...
It goes
to all of us. Man.
Did I give you a workout?
Yeah.
I feel like I lost a couple hours.
You don't have to go to the gym in your place.
I know.
I just said I thought that they should have stayed here for you because you had to stay here for them.
It's only fair.
This is very quick.
Okay. Are you changing the parking spaces around?
Yes, we are. Yeah. We're changing the detention ponds. We're moving them. Okay.
All right, perfect.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just a quick update.
Just in time for winter.
Yeah, I know. I am referencing the email that came from Mike Stady on the 28th and then forwarded to you guys on the 31st. We had hoped Mike was going to be here tonight. He's out of the country, but should be here on the 14th, which is next month. So let me just give you a quick status. As far as the site work, that's all done and we are agreed to. That is the repairing of the roadway between the entrance at 160 all the way down to 152. We do have the hoods put on, the basins. The stakes have all been put in. When you guys do the site visit, the final site visit, we're going to ask you to look at two locations. Due to weather conditions, we weren't too sure that they were putting the sink in the correct place. One of them is behind 2224 Angel Brook as you go down towards, I believe it's three.
Basin three, no, that's the one down by
no, that. So it's one,
okay?
And then the furthest one is, I believe, down by Phil, which I believe is basin number two. And we just need to make sure that they're in the right place. The stakes have been painted, so that's good. So progress has been made.
Yeah,
we are
good.
Still really, really pleased with the work that he's done.
Good.
The next section has to do with the finalized O&M plan. There was a question the last time we were there, here was regarding the riser and the outlet pipes.
Right, and
in one and basin number one and basin number two. You got a letter from the engineer stating that they're not there. We didn't think they were, but we needed something confirmation-wise. So what we've done then is we have consolidated. The last outstanding issue were the two paragraphs. They were separate and distinct. We've consolidated into one paragraph for 1B with the outlet and the riser plates and the conditions for both of those. I took the opportunity to update the O&M plan to read as we would like it to read, because that was the only outstanding issue that was left after our discussion. My question to you is, do you want me to forward it to you? Do you want me to forward it to you and Mike?
Didn't you forward it to us already?
Isn't that this?
It was all marked up. Did you get the final one?
I know, which change?
I consolidated those two outstanding paragraphs. Yeah, it might very well be. So
the basin one, basin 1B and 2 has perforated riser pipes? Is that the?
Yeah, it's gone.
Oh, this one still has it.
Right. Yeah, basin 1B. Right.
This looks the same.
Yep, good. So that would be the one that we would want.
Yeah, so what I was thinking.
Yeah, so we got the other one.
So at this meeting, what I wanted to do is see who wanted to take a walk there with me, or if you guys want to go without me, that'd be good. But, take a walk there and do it maybe at 5 o'clock some evening when it's not raining.
I couldn't get that. When it's hot out?
Not tomorrow.
That's something you never do when it's not raining.
I know.
Right.
I know. But yeah, I can't do it
tomorrow. Friday?
I think it's Friday.
So we get a site walk in. Then we'll walk and see what the risers, what we see. I know I saw something out there. And we'll see what they actually are. And then we'll come back and send the O&M plan to Mike. And maybe at our September meeting we can finish this up.
Okay, good.
So it's going to be Cheryl, you, and Raj? Three volunteer?
Yeah, I mean, we'll have three. If everyone wants to go, that's fine.
I can't get there for 5, but...
Yeah,
six?
Tomorrow and Friday.
Well, and then 6, the bugs come out, and I don't want to go.
Oh, I want you because they'll eat you first. You're right.
So when were you thinking?
Well, I'm not sure now. It's changing.
No, you can go. You can
well,
go.
If it's three of us, that's fine. We're going to need to post
that. We need to post it. So we need 24
so we need
hours.
24
notice.
Hours. So we can't do it.
So Raj can't go.
It's got to be sometime next week.
Yeah. Okay. Then why don't you email either Phil?
Well, we got to figure out. I got to figure out these guys first. That's,
and then
go without me.
Yes, you guys live there, so I think
we'll
be there.
Yeah, we'll be there.
So
just let us know.
I'm not
just you two
Tuesdays.
Go on Friday if you want to
does
do.
Does the weekend work?
Get it over.
Saturday is not work. Yeah, the week
okay.
Saturday or Sunday won't work for me, but Friday would.
So to go on Friday is our. I mean,
we need
doesn't give us
well,
time.
Well, two are going. We don't need to post.
Yeah,
it.
Yeah. Then you're all set.
Right.
That's true.
We'll tell Raj you can't go.
I'd like to go, but at the same time, I don't want to hold it up.
Right.
Well, that's what does next week look like? When can you get up? When can you?
I can get home, you know, one day next week, say for 6.
Yeah, probably.
Monday and Thursday won't work. So I have meetings.
Tuesday, I've got soccer practice at 6.
What about
Wednesday,
so Wednesday. Or next
Wednesday?
Wednesday?
I think Wednesday works.
Next Wednesday should work for me.
Wednesday at 6?
Wednesday at 6.
The 17th, that should work.
One post that.
A week from tonight at 6?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I could do that.
Meet at the club.
So post it just in case.
Yeah.
Wednesday.
Will they be wine and crackers?
17th.
Or cheese and crackers. Cheese and crackers.
Oh. Cheese and rice.
Cheese and crackers at the clubhouse.
Okay,
oh, good.
Have just a couple of last
that'll
things.
Go. At what time?
6.
The discussion on the as built plans. Mike states that he doesn't need them. We don't need you.
Yeah,
he won't do them. I'm deferring.
I haven't seen the as-built plans. I wasn't sure. I know they were in an email somewhere.
Okay.
So I was trying to dig them out before the meeting and I couldn't find them.
This would be with the 1B.
Yeah, they had the 1B
awesome.
Shown.
Okay.
But they also, I think the question was whether they show the risers, but since the risers are not there, there's nothing to show. So I don't know that they need it.
We are going to defer to you on that decision. There are some that think that we should have them and you should have them if required, that he should do them.
Well, we should have the as-built that reflect what's going on
good.
On the site. If
okay.
they don't, and that's what we Have you seen them, the as-bills? Do you think we could get a copy?
Is he just saying that he's already done them? Is that what, is that what the issue is?
Yeah, he did them a year ago.
Yeah.
And...
But we need it, as Vinny said, to reflect really what is there.
So what I want to do is try to track down the as-bills. Okay. What's the current as-bill? Maybe,
I mean, if he's got just a copy, if he can find his email, well, too.
Well, and here's the next part of this same question. At the Conservation Committee meeting last week, they made the recommendation any documentation, be it the O&M, the as-built, this letter from the engineer, be on heritage, letterhead, signed, stamped, dated.
Well, that's always been what we were talking about for the O&M, wasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, the O&M thing, I can see it. The rest, I don't, I mean, an email from them, it shouldn't...
The email is going to be fine.
Yeah, what matters is the O&M plan and
the as-built. And the as-built.
I'm pretty sure an as-built has to have a stamp on it anyway. Yeah. It's got to have engineer stuff, so,
okay, so
I
think
it is, but I haven't seen them, so...
So this is fine for you.
Has it got the engineer's name and all that stuff?
It's got the engineer's name. I don't know where it's from. It's, there's no signature here. So I have no idea.
That's the letter.
That's just the letter.
Yeah, that's just, I look at that as being kind of like an email that they don't believe we need to do, go out and change an as-built plan on something that was designed, wasn't built, and they didn't locate it in the field.
Can an as-built be modified by a letter?
Saying page 3, this pond, these structures aren't there?
Well, no, the as-built shouldn't show a structure unless it's there.
Okay.
That's the idea, and that's why I think if they're not there, and they don't want to put in that this is where it should have been, type of thing.
It's where something might have been.
Yeah.
Okay. And gentlemen, and Melanie and Christine, I think that's Cheryl. I think that's it. Unless you have any questions from us. Like I said.
I look forward to the sidewalk.
Yeah.
All right. So it's going to be next Wednesday.
Wednesday, 6 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. At the clubhouse.
At Curtis's new cafeteria?
At Curtis's new cafeteria.
Okay, good. Yeah,
let's hope for nice weather, huh?
Yeah. Okay, at 6 p.m. If anything changes, let us know. Did you have anything else?
I do not. Next month, we should be here with Mr.
Yes,
Stady.
Yes, we should be here with Mr. Stady.
We'll all be smiling.
And signing checks?
He'll be happy, yes.
Yes, he will. Oh, and yes. Like I said, we have been very, very pleased and very happy. Good.
Well,
reception.
I'll say it again. I'm very impressed with the homeowners group, you know, and how thorough you guys are doing. I mean,
thank you.
Best
we
of the
best.
Great job.
We'll pass it along.
Yes.
Sometimes if you want it done, you got to.
There you go.
Yeah.
Amen.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Let's call Mr. Sarabian.
Oh, he'll be back.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, he'll be back. If you need anything.
Thank you.
Have a
good
evening.
You too.
All right, so I just wanted to go back.
25 Fairbanks.
Oh, yes. Come on up. 25 Fairbanks, A&R. How are you?
That's why these are out.
Yes, see?
Good.
I should have picked up on that, but I'm slow tonight for some reason.
Basically, I'm trying to sell my house at 25 Fairmont Street, but the people who are buying it only want to buy 1 acre, a little bit more than 1 acre. So we have re-subdivided the lot, and my understanding is that I can't just subdivide the lot and leave a landlocked piece of land, so our neighbor is going to accept the additional property. So,
and that's noted on the plans?
Yeah. I believe so.
Oh,
I didn't do the plan.
Wouldn't that show on the plan that his property...
Yeah,
I'm
probably
not sure.
Somewhere.
Yeah. I just didn't do the plan, so I don't know.
You're delivering.
I'm just...
You would have done them differently, more color.
Oh, here it is. The purpose of this plan.
Ron is available by phone if we need to ask him any questions. He wasn't able to come to the meeting.
Let me just read through this.
Sure.
Just to get on the record here. The purpose of this plan is to divide the land of Lisa Bellotta currently to lot 1R.
We just found it.
Revised.
Do you want me to take this off so you don't
see that
perfect. Yeah, exactly. Lot 1R revised and parcel A as shown.
So here's
1R, here's A.
Right, so this used to be the lot right here.
Yep.
And now we're just taking this off, and this is gonna be the new lot, and we're giving this land to the neighbor.
And so this is all landlocked around here, is what you're saying, for this portion?
This part would be landlocked.
You would have been landlocked, but that's being given to parcel.
As parcel is shown here, parcel A is not to be considered an independent building lot. Parcel A is to be conveyed to and combined with the land owned by George J. Aziz Jr. and Deborah Lee, what is it, Pepe Aziz, to form one undivided lot shown as lot 1L revised. 1L revised, so that would be this and
this.
This,
all of that.
It's on the plan.
That's good.
That works?
Nope. This does not reflect under the signatures.
No determination of compliance with zoning has been made. Do you like that?
Yep. What else we have?
Frontage.
You got it. How much do we have for the two lots?
This one, we've got, 127, which this is single residence, if I recall.
Yep.
So we need 120, so that's good. What, on this one here?
Yep.
It says, 99.60? But I don't know if that includes this piece here. I don't think it does. There's another 22 and another 20, so that would get us up over 120.
So that looks all right.
And none of this is changing.
Yep.
You know.
Yeah, we signed off on that a few
years
ago.
Right, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Excellent.
The only thing that's changing is that they're taking on this.
So you're sort of splitting this
right
away from this, and then you're sort of redrawing their lot
right
as well.
Mm-hmm.
Do we have the Form A's?
Oh, you didn't bring that?
I thought
you would have brought the whole
I'm sorry.
Problem.
Yeah, no,
did you email that to us? I think you did, didn't you?
Yeah.
I think you emailed it to the board, right?
I thought she was going to bring the whole entire thing with her, so I'm not even sure if I put it in here.
You might have it here.
I do have that.
This one?
Yeah, that was a fee.
And Ron told me that I made a mistake. I circled both one and two, and he said I wasn't supposed to circle one.
You filled out two.
There it is.
Have you submitted to the town clerk yet?
No, it wasn't, because you just sent this to me Friday, or we did it over the weekend.
Worried about that. Usually gets your time frame started. I think you need to do just to complete it, but it's not going to bother us. It won't change anything we do.
Okay. So I just need to some part that
is completed. There's the four-time one, but there's nothing else.
Mm-hmm.
Second page right there. She stamps it as being
received. Okay.
It's just those further surrounding.
Yep.
Do we
that's
really
great.
Need that if they're bringing it in?
You're very good with this.
I know, it's
nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We did it over the weekend anyway, didn't we? What day did we do it?
I think Friday.
It looks like this foundation only just doesn't show up on there, just the front, the main building.
And so this is all just undeveloped land. There's no structures there, no. Okay.
There's a tree house over here.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
We'll let that
slide. We'll have to let the assessors know.
That is another part to act on in 21 days. So that starts the time clock.
It's been cool. I appreciate it.
Okay.
I know. I remember those days. Those were good times.
So actually, that guy's going to end up with a nice spot, you know?
Yeah.
It's going to be this and a huge chunk of land back there.
Yeah, yeah. Mm.
Could do something.
I don't know if he said he doesn't really want any land.
He just needs to pay more taxes. That's all.
Yeah, exactly.
George has always been a smart, very smart guy.
So, did you find the application?
Yes.
Is everything in order?
And you're the sole owner, right?
Sole owner.
Somebody want to make a motion? Or?
There was a question. A fee that has not been taken.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
The what?
Oh, fee.
Oh, so
oh.
We don't have that.
Sure.
How much does it need? How many lots?
Two lots, right?
So it's two lots.
So it's, I forget what.
Was it 150 plus 150? Still with them?
I don't recall.
There's two lots in the end.
I should have printed it out.
Where
I still have it.
I don't. I think he's got it in front of his. Somebody had it right in their notebook.
Yeah.
right in the front.
Is filing fees, $200 plus $100 per lot.
$400.
Plus the boat fee.
Dividing any, an existing lot into two lots results in two lots, a fee of $400 as an example. But this is...
This is kind of just, you're starting with two lots, you're ending up with two lots.
There's already two lots.
I'd be okay with doing a $200 filing fee and a $100 review, because it's really one lot.
Me too.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
The lots already exist, it's just swapping property.
I agree, $300.
$300?
And who do I make that to?
Vinnie Vignali.
So was there a motion on that?
I didn't hear one.
There was not a motion on that. I make a motion.
Motion to
endorse.
To endorse.
Love that word.
The
because we don't, it's a not approved.
Proposed A&R plan at 25 Fairbanks Street as
presented.
Submitted.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
What's the name?
Now we have to sign. It takes a little
while. Yeah, sign. We'll be here half an hour, but we'll get it done.
What, where's the application? I just need to write down.
I think it's over there.
It'll be much faster.
Can we borrow the application for a moment?
Set them up.
Just for the
name.
You know, do we write the number on here too?
We don't normally put the number on the Form A, do we?
Not on the Form A, no.
I didn't think so.
So,
it started me.
We just do Lisa A and pull out a simple?
Yep. Sole owner.
What?
Sole owner. She said.
I couldn't fill it in because I didn't have it. Wasn't true.
Not a problem.
Remember.
Got the Sharpie here for the.
What did we say the date was? 8?
Today's 8/10.
Wait a minute. We haven't done anything in 2016 yet?
Wow, that's surprising. First A&R
of the year. First A&R of the year?
That's good.
Really?
That surprises me.
I know.
Seemed like we had one every other meeting for a while there.
Great. Right or wrong, we had one every other meeting.
Do they have to bring the Mylar? Do they have to record that now?
Yes.
Yeah. So
yeah.
That one, someone has to be recorded.
Yeah, you take the Mylar back and you can sign that one.
Okay. So there is some possibility that this deal doesn't go through, so can I wait until...
Yeah. Once we sign it, it's...
Once the check is cashed.
But don't forget to, because then it's not legal until it gets recorded, registered.
It's like a conditional at this point? Or?
So should I hold those two then until she tells me it's a done deal? Because I would be giving that to the assessors and...
Oh no, once we do it, the town handles all the taxes and all the other stuff that way. But when they start looking at deed research, the deed research will be legal tax to the registry of deeds. And if someone else records something. Actually, I don't know how that would be a problem with this one. It's.
So,
George
pays all your taxes, but we still own it.
Right.
Never found that.
The number, if we want to start writing the number up there.
It's still okay to distribute it to everybody.
Yep, whenever we just get it and we distribute it.
Does it need to be on each one of these?
Yeah, like right up here. 8, 10, 16, 81, P1.
Right here?
Yeah.
Perfect.
Away from the signatures.
You want to do the Mylar?
What
does
it say,
81,
81P1.
It could be.
Put the Mylar down. Should have to sit through enough.
Yeah. I think we should adjust the parking on this and the intersection. Oh, wait, I'm down at the bottom now.
No, second from the bottom.
Are you second from the bottom?
You're at the bottom. Bottom.
Down here?
You're newest. That's a Mylar pen.
Yep, she's using it.
What?
I like how they feel in my hand.
All right, good.
Yeah, I'm with you.
There's another one. Do you need one, Minnie?
See, it comes right through onto this.
Oh.
I'm just kidding.
Can do them all.
If we do them all once. My bottom line is too close to the edge room. Did you sign for Raj?
No. Well, that's right, Raj. Right?
You spelled your name wrong? See, that's why you have to send a signature like this. It doesn't even know if it's wrong.
I know. Really? Go ahead.
Oh, damn. Here's a book.
Thank you.
And do you need that copy of the application that we were in around?
Before May?
Before May?
I think.
I need it.
Okay.
Thank you.
I just want to make sure I flick it just right so yeah. Make it not go everywhere.
Flick it.
I think some of those need the, oh, they got the ring. Do you still live at the, do you still live in one of these? No. Oh, well.
And then do I keep some of this?
You get one.
The best one.
Okay, so we're going to tie. Is this one you got your name spelled right, or is it?
Okay. No, it was on the Mylar.
Oh.
I think so.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good luck.
You can go right up there.
I wish they could all be that straightforward.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Is this yours?
All right, now we're gonna rocket through the rest of this in about, so let's say 20 minutes.
I like how you think.
Don't we have to redo it all when Raj gets back?
Oh, he can watch it when he gets home.
Okay.
What's that? All right, let me go up to the top here. 99 Hartwell Street drainage update. I just got an update literally within an hour before the meeting started from Mr. McCredichian, who...
Okay.
Represents the owner, and he received confirmation and forwarded along to us from Waste Management that they are satisfied with the work that had been done to alleviate the issue. So they're happy. Last I spoke with the Divertis at 99 Hartwell,
mm-hmm.
They said they were under the impression they had dealt with it, and the matter was complete. So. I think we can resolve that.
Perfect.
I think we're good there.
All right.
Great. One other thing. Now,
are we waiting for the as-built on that? Or has that already been submitted?
There was no outside changes.
What?
No, that's a screwed up one.
That's the one with the biggest...
No, he came up back with the drain.
Came back to an amendment. Yeah.
No, I don't think... We haven't received as-built on that.
Oh, no, they were working on it because there were questions on what to include in the as-built. So... I got a funny feeling they're going to want their occupancy permit really quickly.
I think they're doing what they got to do. I don't think we're slowing them down.
Okay.
I mean, I think UPS and everything are doing their training out there and everything. I don't think that Yeah, I mean, I...
Well, right, but I'm afraid we're going to have another one of our site plan reviews that never gets finished up. We don't get an as-built, and we don't do a completion.
Well, I mean, I can certainly send an email, Mr. Verdi, saying, you know, now that this issue appears to be behind us, you know, we'd like to, you know, complete the process and can give us a time frame for the as-built, et cetera.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Okay.
And the building inspector, at the last meeting, did you guys talk about certificate of completions?
No.
Who's...
Mean in general?
Yeah, just...
No.
Because in the past, we've always just done them to finish our projects and get everything closed out. But it is in the bylaw that it's the building inspector that issues.
I sent in an email to that... Oh, no, wait, I'm sorry. That was Cumberland Farms, I believe.
Yeah, I think you might have sent him something about that as well. And I just wasn't sure. I thought... Because that was before the last meeting, and I thought you might have spoken about it at the last meeting, but...
I'm not... I don't believe...
I remember what we talked about.
We talked about, I think, everything except that at the last meeting.
Yeah, I heard it was a marathon meeting.
It was.
Almost as bad as this one.
Yeah, this is shaping up.
We got 2 hours to go.
Oh, thank God.
All right, so at any rate, I'll send an email, but at least the drainage issue appears to be to the satisfaction of all parties involved.
So we can proceed, I mean, then...
I think so, yeah. Number two, has a second aspect regarding Cumberland Farms, because I know the building inspector reached out to me week before last, mentioning that he was under the impression that because Cumberland Farms is nearing completion, that he was anticipating that they'd be seeking an occupancy permit relatively soon. So he was reaching out to see, are there any outstanding issues before us? And that was when I reached out to Graves for an update to see, you know, can you give us an updated status?
Yeah.
So what's the inspection? We mentioned the issue with the curb cut on Route 12, which didn't appear to be sort of quite as angled as I think it was on the plan.
It's like they show them right there.
Yes, exactly. And what I have here, thank you, Melanie, is actually this latest Graves report. It was dated, 2 days ago, August 8th.
You just did that in the mail?
So I was reading through it. It looks like... All right, so here's the curb cut, according to our engineer. West Boylston Street curb cut, specifically the curb lines have been modified to be at an angle with West Boylston Street to discourage exiting southbound turns, as shown on the approved plans. GEI notes the curb cut angle with West Boylston Street and the curb radii appear to be slightly less than shown on the plans. The curb appears closer to perpendicular than shown on the plan. So that's, I guess...
We have a copy of the plan. I'm not sure which way it's going.
It's what they just gave us. It's on this one.
Yeah.
Oh, so now instead of it having that angle of going back, it's straight.
Well,
that's what it sounds like.
It is angled, but he's saying it looks like it's not as much as what was on the plan.
I don't remember again the signs, but we need to have that sign as no left turns.
Yeah.
I think we... had that in the approval.
I'm pretty sure we did, yeah.
No left turn?
But he does say...
Yeah.
Yeah, the problem is no left turn coming in off of Route 12.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the issue.
Oh,
is that further on?
Yeah.
I didn't read that.
No, so he doesn't mention anything about left turns onto the property. After talking about that the curb radii isn't quite as sharp as what the plan appears, he does go on and say, Graves believes that the intent is substantially met and signage and pavement markings make it clear that vehicles shall not exit at this curb cut.
Yeah.
But he's still not addressing the entrance.
The problem is the entrance. We weren't so worried about that.
Yeah. However, only an as-built survey would reveal any deviations between the constructed curb cut and approved site plan curb cut alignments.
Because right. Whenever we do these, I know over at CVS, VHB did that line.
Yeah.
We didn't like it at the time, and I've almost gotten picked off twice. It's been 8 years or
yeah.
so.
Yeah.
I got yelled at the
shoot answer. Across that way, and shoot across at the entrance only, even though it says no left turn coming north on Route 12. Like shoot in there.
And that one's got a little island, right?
Right.
As opposed to this one.
Yeah, and we wanted to make. I wanted to make it a higher island.
Yeah.
Well, that's a two-way one though.
But
this one's only an entrance.
Yeah, I know. That's the way it should be. But
all right. Well, given that his comments here, he's not mentioning enter, you know, left-hand turn enters. I mean, maybe I can follow up with him and say, you know, what's your position on that?
Or ask him to look for, in the plan or whatever, to make sure that there's the no left turn sign is addressed.
I don't recall if these have anything on it other than Cumberland Farms, because
I think they say welcome.
Welcome.
Is it just welcome?
Come again or something like that.
Oh, okay, so it doesn't have any direction on it.
That is a directional sign, that's what you guys approved.
Well, we did for welcome, yeah, we did.
Waive strict compliance.
Yeah, but you didn't have the.
I don't have those pictures.
That was fine.
Melanie didn't deliver me a packet with those pictures in it.
That's a very odd.
Of what?
Of your pack.
What's a good looking sign?
Oh.
I have them in there.
Oh, this graves, oh, the graves are four.
See?
Kind of like the Hojos.
What?
It's not Hojos anymore.
We still call it Hojos.
So there is a sidewalk over by the crosswalk that it.
Yep.
And this crosswalk just goes, or this sidewalk goes to like, nothing. It just stops. Which I guess is appropriate because there's nothing there.
Well, it'd be going down the hill.
We're gonna get something, we're little bits at a time.
All right, unless Sarabian's involved.
Well, no, the next one down.
I think it's more important from the opposite side down, so, because I see people walking toward Walmart and up.
Well, but there's a crosswalk at Walmart, so if they can walk down this side.
True.
It's still safe, but yeah.
Well, there is a sidewalk over here.
Yep. All right, so he does go on and note a couple of other things, and they all appear to be to his satisfaction. Interior work, concrete dumpster pad with gates now installed, site perimeter, sediment erosion controls, so you're fine. Pavement markings, traffic signage been completed. Lawn area substantially stabilized. Wood guard rail has been installed. And he says, the site work is now substantially complete with the exception of the following items. And there's a few items here, but pavement, some pavement markings, an air tower has not been installed. I don't even know what that is.
I think it's a vent.
Is that what it is?
Oh, no, it's the air tower is for air filling your tires.
An air tower.
Oh, yeah, but he says, but the location is electrically wired. Outlet pipe of catch basin CB3 needs to be cut back to near flush with the interior face. Drain manhole poured concrete inverts have not yet been constructed. Loam and seating need to be completed. Connection of new site sewer service needs to be modified. Utility line testing. Testing reports shall be submitted to appropriate town departments. But that's what he's saying is outstanding. So I guess one of the questions that I had was, now that we've got this report, I mean, I'll reach out to Graves again and ask him about that left turn only, about signs and turning radius and all that. But does the board, or would the board, I mean, I feel like I want to give the building inspector an update since he initially reached out.
Yeah.
And so, with respect to the occupancy permit that is probably forthcoming, I think we did, in fact, I think I did at least mention to him in the past that because of the bylaw, talking about the certificate of completion and all of that, that, I mean, we certainly don't want to hold them up, that one option was the temporary occupancy idea for
the 30 day or whatever.
For 30 days or whatever, with the understanding that Cumberland Farms knows they need to come back to us and finish the process to get the full occupancy. I don't know what you
that
guys
makes
do.
Sense. That's, we've done that in the past, so that's
and that gets him okay. Some
make
reasonable.
Sure it's a limited time, because I think like the liquor store is still on there temporary.
Yeah,
and
my brother,
cousin.
All right, so I'll follow up with him on that as well.
7:30.
Almost.
We're getting there. Temp. Occupancy. And you know what? I just remembered. I forgot while Mr. Sarabian was here. We need funds to cover the review that we've done, and we need funds to cover
You should have held his phone.
I should have remembered that, but I didn't, so.
I think Wayne actually is the one who brought it up.
Yeah.
In his mail, yeah.
Because I mentioned to him that, there were no funds. I said, well, we'll go ahead.
I thought there was a little bit.
Yeah, $6.
Yeah.
Oh, see?
He said, we'll go ahead and do it anyways, just ask for the money. So, need to go ahead and do that. I can send an email.
Yeah, that'd probably be fine.
Is there a...
He's going to be at the ZBA.
I think he had suggested somewhere 9 to 15 to cover the work that he's done so far, but if there's any further work, we might want to request more than that. So I don't know if anybody has a suggestion.
I think he's going to be hard to get money from, so we might as well go for the big number first. Yeah.
Well, I think let's not try to do any special stuff. This is an amended site plan review. It's a site plan. Professional review fee is $800, and the application fee is $600. So they pay the fees.
Plus the review we did now, or we roll it all together.
Well, no, this is that's going into the construction, because he wants construction supervision, which is a different fee.
Yeah.
Which construction site inspection, which was for less than 3 acres, was $3,000. I don't think we use that much. Depends on how much it goes back and forth.
Yeah, right, exactly.
I mean, because that's the thing, that you let them know that the more they
squabble.
Yeah.
Right, the more
you
claim. Well, they want an answer from us, but I mean, like, the answer isn't obvious, so.
Well, could be for some, but they don't like that answer.
That's a good way to put it.
Like, I was just, like, this thing, the way they redid the island, you know, in front of that other curb cut will be like right here now.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, if we extended this whole thing back further with this do not block, whatever, marking in the road, I don't know how successful those are ever, you know, but I mean, that might allow the curb cut to be mismatched, but the intersection just to be wide enough to let people negotiate it, you know, but that's a traffic engineer's never works.
I mean, I think that's a good idea, but
you know. But it's not may not work.
Police. Let them do their thing.
All right. So for the fee, I just want to, where do we settle on?
We're going to do the $1,400? Oh, no, $1,400 will be... No,
that will only cover the work that's been done so far.
No, well, the 14... Was it 14? 8 and 6?
He'd said,
I think... $1,500 for what he's done now so far for construction review.
Right. Okay.
But...
There's going to be more.
There's going to be even more on construction review, but I don't know how much more than that $1,500. We'll see how as it goes, but generally they do the site plan, amended site plan, and that's the $1,400. That's going to look at all the different options. So it may be that some of the money that they've already used under the construction review gets billed to that. But that's the way we want to do it is, if it's a site plan review, it comes out of that money, and if it's construction inspection, it's a separate bit of money.
Okay.
I mean, he wants to just go out and do it, and then we'll talk about it later.
Yeah.
We got to follow some kind of a process.
Well, we also have to make him so he doesn't do the wrong thing. We don't want him to just go do it and then
come
back later and say it's a mess.
Right.
Because you're never going to get him to change it. Yeah. I mean, later on, like the Dairy Queen, you're never going to...
Yeah, I know. Yes, I agree. Yeah, so we want to work with them, and we want to make it as quick as possible. Luckily, we're going to be meeting in a month, right?
Yeah, 14th, I think.
14th?
I don't know.
So that should give the time to pull stuff together, to get all the comments, and then we just make the decision then. It should be easy. But getting all the legwork done is the key.
Yeah, whenever it gets in here, I can't just do it from now.
Right.
That's amended. Does he have to advertise all that and everything, or not?
He
doesn't.
He submits an amended.
What's
the
other one?
We decide whether it's going to be a public meeting, so it'll be posted as
preliminary site plan. You don't get advertised.
It will be a public.
It's at a public meeting, not a public hearing.
Okay. So when he brings it in, it will still get distributed to different departments, right? For their for their opinion.
Yep, that's the point. Yep. So we got to scratch the 30-day response time. We need it in a week or so.
Oh, Well, whenever he gets it in, I'll figure out the date when I need it by.
Okay. All right.
If he gets it in soon.
Okay. And you all, are you all set, Chris, with the amounts and what?
Yeah, so I mean, I'll mention the 1500, but then there may also be some additional, inspection.
Oh, there definitely will be.
After that, so, I mean, I'll suggest a number, see what he says.
Can you do like 2000 or something like that? Or do you want to go way high and cover the, like, go 3000, and then we have sort of two inspections?
3000 is what the bylaws, or what our fee schedule says, yeah. And if he doesn't...
For the construction inspection.
He can get it back.
He gets it back, right?
So, and that would be in addition to the 15 that you mentioned.
14, yeah.
Or the 14.
Yeah.
So, 14 plus 3,000 to start with, and we'll see where we end up.
And
so
then, I think that should be adequate.
We'll see, I guess, what kind of pushback we get.
Well,
we won't get any pushback.
That's the fee, like you say.
Right.
So. All right. So, all right. We'll do that. Wow, village zoning. I think I can do this in about 30 seconds. So, as the board may recall, after last meeting, we sent out the letter to get any feedback from various boards and departments in town.
Yep.
And the Brenda Bowman board piped up.
Yes.
Twice.
We did get response from four people. Let's see, I've got them written down here.
Oh, really?
Yes. I did get, I got acknowledgments essentially of receipt from the town clerk on the bylaws committee, and also John
Mindersma.
Mindersma. They didn't provide
any... Mindersma for the bylaws committee?
It's a town moderator.
So they acknowledged receipt, but substantive comments. Similarly, Mike on Open Space, he also...
Oh, Mike Pecker?
Yes. He had a question about, do you have any additional information on village zoning? I sent him some of the stuff that CMRPC had sent along. Mm-hmm. Yes.
I was going to say, because I had one too.
How did it get to Open Space?
I think I copied them. I think they were one of the boards that I copied, wasn't it?
I was at the July meeting, the 9:30 staff meeting,
yes,
here, there were a couple of committees that did ask that it get forwarded on to them, and so Chris did, and I'm not...
Oh.
That was...
But no, that wasn't that. It wasn't...
That was bylaws.
It was the bylaws.
Okay.
Yeah.
It was bylaws.
I mean, the more the merrier, I think.
Yeah. Yeah.
At this point, that's, I figure, what we're looking for.
Did you hear back
from
them?
Bylaws? They just acknowledged receipt.
Brenda wasn't thrilled with it.
And I did get something from the chief, which was...
Actually,
he was talking about the noise, I think, in the neighborhood.
You know what? That, I have to say, that a business needs that would not bring an excessive noise to a neighborhood that would negatively impact the area. I really don't see the value in that, because there's no definition to excessive noise in a neighborhood that negatively impacts the area, as we have neighborhoods now where shooting...
Right,
is,
I mean, it's louder than Wayne's,
and
I think we know it's not.
Quite loud.
Right.
The town does not think that that is too loud. So I think we could pretty much have 18-wheelers coming and going, and it wouldn't have the same velocity as the guns going off. So I think we're good.
Well, and I think that sort of one way of dealing with that issue is, if, as we've talked about in the past, is if we put in something in the proposed bylaw that sort of limits the type of businesses that would be allowed to be in professional offices, to being dentists,
silent,
and lawyers.
Love that noise of the drill.
Well, then have limited hours. I mean, they wouldn't be there
right
on the weekends and stuff.
Right.
We want a gun range.
Clearly.
Clearly.
I just find it interesting that Brenda Bowman agrees with Dennis Minnick. Those are the two comments we got.
We'll have to tell her.
Write this date down, right? All right, so those are the comments we received.
Any conversation I can.
But at least more to the point, when and if we do get to town meeting with some kind of a draft, at least we can go there with the backing saying, We were trying, we tried to be open, we tried to reach out, effort, try to get people's...
When I was at the Board of Selectmen meeting, I tried to get the point across that we didn't want to do this if people weren't interested.
Yes.
And I don't think that they quite got that. They said, well, we'll check it out when we get a draft. I'm like, well, I'm kind of trying, if we don't have to write a draft, if you don't want us to do it, you know.
Well, I think that, but we also want to let the abutters and the people who are living in these areas know that it may not fly. I mean, we went down this road one time, I think it was 7 or 8 years ago. We started looking at it and we decided it wasn't for West Boylston. So we may go down the road and not support it.
Well, they did bring up the,
we need to look at
the sort of the twist, and I said to them, maybe one of the things you could take advantage of a village zoning bylaw or overlay is to increase your controls in those areas, like we talked about. So you could, you know, if there's things you don't like, this is your opportunity to fix them in this mechanism rather than change all the zoning for the whole, you know, everything business, which would go up and down through Walmart and everything, but you don't really care about that. You want it where it's right next to residents, you know, and then you make them quieter in different hours and things like that. I mean, again, I don't think it didn't matter. They wanted to see a draft.
Yeah, and did the issue of parking come up at
all? Yeah, it was parking and traffic were the biggest things.
Okay. Because, yeah, I mean, honestly, that's something that I've been thinking of. I've been trying to come up with a way that we can sort of deal with the parking issue, because I certainly agree that already this area is sort of congested. We wouldn't want, obviously, we don't want people parking on the side of the street. There's, you know...
Unless there's room. I mean, you know, like they...
We just did it sidewalk, so...
Right.
The option to put in a little pocket... parallel parking spaces
kind of
disappeared once they redid the sidewalk.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, the sidewalk is an important thing. It's a good thing.
Yeah.
I knew we shouldn't have done sidewalks.
Well,
I'm just kidding.
You should have done it earlier, is what it is. But, I mean, I think what the points you're making are absolutely true. Those are things we need to talk about with CMRPC. Traffic, just the flow, parking, and noise. And then probably lighting or the other things.
One of Brenda's biggest things was the road right in front of the municipal lighting plant, like during school dismissals and drop-off times, is, you know, like a standstill.
Oh, it's lined up with cars.
Yeah. So she said there's no sense in having anything more for business or something generating more traffic there, you know, at those spots.
Right. You know. Yeah, and the other thing, too, which makes this a bit of a challenge is as we've seen in this area, you know, the center of town area that we're talking about, there are some areas on Route 12 that are zoned business, others are zoned for residential.
In
general residence, exactly. And so to the extent that we're going to go ahead with an overlay, we're not going to be able to put any further restrictions on the underlying business zone or the types of businesses that can move in there. An overlay is just going to add to that, isn't it? That's my understanding.
You can't add a restriction.
I thought you could restrict it unless it's an existing.
I'm not sure that you can restrict the base zone from an overlay.
Good question to ask.
I remember we brought this up, and we may have to do a genuine zone change.
Right, exactly. Which would make us lean towards
which is
a new zoning change, which is a little bit more onerous, but maybe might get us to something that people actually want.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And realigning the zoning too, so it kind of lines up with what's really there. I think that was one of the things we noticed, is that some of the business, like the zoning edges, didn't line up with the real edges of the properties.
Yeah. You know? Let me just write this down.
Which would be better, changing of zoning rather than an overlay. Yeah. Because an overlay will just hit what's there.
Yeah. But I also remember a cautionary note, again, from CMRPC with regard to changing the underlying zoning district. And the caution was that, in general, those kinds of things are much more difficult to get through a town meeting. Because, you know, the business is there. They don't want to give up opportunities for, you know, certain businesses moving into their places. So.
I'm not worried. I've been batting 1,000 with these signed bylaws, so I think we'll...
All right, so we've got a number of things.
But these signed bylaws, we've gone through twice and they both passed.
That's true.
Oh, yeah.
That's true. We've got a good track record. I don't want to mess it up with this.
Did you hear from her from from CMRPC? Because I haven't heard back from her, and I didn't know if I should reach out. On the signs, because they were reviewing.
They were working on them in Sutton, and she was supposed to get back.
Jane said she was going to call me back or email me to let me know what was going on with Sutton. Both Chris and I had reached out to her. I had a phone call.
I don't think I've received anything yet.
I haven't received anything yet either, but she said
that she would be
sure to pass it on.
Yeah, that was end of summer when I
did it. It's still on it.
Well, no, she was supposed to be, because she and I had a phone conversation, and so she was going to actually try to call me the following week to let me know some of her preliminary work.
Okay.
And so then I didn't know if you actually had been the one to hear from her.
We did get an email from somebody who was impressed with our...
But I wasn't able to read it within the last day or two. Let me just see if I can find it.
Oh.
It was an email that said that we had gone pretty far with our... Or was that a different lady?
Yeah, that was the one she liked.
Oh, there's one on historic preservation.
She liked what we had done so far.
We had done so far, yeah.
And
yes, that...
Jane was going to... And then you were going to talk to her or something.
Yeah, but
I don't know what the timing was. I don't know if that was a response.
Oh, no, I don't. Oh,
that wasn't
I don't remember.
No, I haven't, so I haven't received anything.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, I haven't received anything since then. Yeah.
So you may want to contact
her. Sorry, I didn't mean to.
No, me neither.
Take you off track. All right.
No, no, not at all. All right, so I guess.
You're going to contact Jane, right?
Jane, yes. Yep. I will.
The doctor, the veterinarian there that lost his. The doctor.
Tajan.
Isn't his house. Isn't that on Central Street? Would that be in the village zoning district?
I'm not sure where his house is. Which one?
Right behind Central Market there.
The one next to the Central.
Oh,
Street
you mean
Market?
The veterinary place?
Yeah, that would be in it.
Yeah.
Well,
that was the area that we walked.
It's too bad the town couldn't get that land and make it a parking lot, and then people, you know, using the village zoning could park there.
I understand that it's sold. Somebody else owns it now.
Yeah, it's,
yeah.
I think someone new owns it, but it needs a lot of work. That's again, that's one of those things the town is going to have to buy property.
Oh, I understand what you're saying, but I mean, I think that would be something that could maybe alleviate some of the parking. You know?
Yeah. All right, let's try to keep this moving here.
It's a village zoning done?
Yeah, you've run out of time.
Yes, I have. I've used my allotted 20 minutes.
You do.
All right, so we've got three ZBA letter drafts that I wanted to discuss tonight. The first one on the agenda is 101 Goodale Street. So now that I guess the petition for a variance that was up at the ZBA has been withdrawn, and they've now, in its place, submitted the special permit for an accessory apartment, which it seemed to make more cities. Originally, it looked like it was a special permit accessory. Then something happened and it changed into a variance at some point, and that's how the ZBA dealt with it at the last meeting in July, was for a variance.
Okay. Weren't you there with us?
What's that?
Weren't you at that
yes,
meeting?
Yes, yeah, okay. I was there. And when Christina sort of asked why they had requested a variance as opposed to a special permit, I think the answer was essentially that they didn't really understand the difference.
Or that the building department had suggested it or something. There was some sort of
miscommunication.
Yeah, I thought Bentley had suggested that he did not tell them to go seek a variance, that he was talking to them about the accessory apartment bylaw. So at any rate, it was determined at the meeting with the CBA that the variance was sort of not the proper mechanism for this. They withdrew. And I think in part of that was because the standard for a variance is so high. So they withdrew that, and they're now, I guess, resubmitting a special permit, largely for the same, with the same information. So I just had a quick look at the information that they submitted with now this updated special permit request. And it appears that really it's the same information that was there before. I don't see really anything new. There's sort of a hand-drawn version.
They wanted to know what the ZBA needed to know was what the size of the existing house was.
Oh, they had to redo their homework so that the increase wasn't 100% increase. Yeah, because what they were saying is they had this little tiny house.
Yeah, and I don't see any of that information.
And they were adding the addition completely outside of the house, which was clearly more than the 10%, you know? So they had to sort of get with the building inspector to see how to calculate a house size. It's like the square footage is increasing, but the exterior of the house is not increasing because they are finishing unfinished space in the house that didn't count towards the square footage they felt. Because it was just the loft or whatever in the garage, and now they're finishing that. Mm-hmm. So they hadn't counted that as finished space before.
Yeah, so that was one of the points that I was getting at in the draft letter. It's the paragraph, section 3, 4, C5. The bottom of the page, where we talk about, it appears the garage expansion begun last year may have been intended to function as an accessory apartment, seems to be much more than the allowed increase of 10%. Planning board discussed whether the term original structure should be interpreted, so the original structure comes right out of the bylaw, whether it should be interpreted as meaning the structure in existence prior to the garage addition, or include the existing structure as of the date of the petition. And then it goes on to caution that if the CBA decides, well, it's as of the petition date, then it seems like that's kind of a hole in the bylaw that somebody could take advantage of.
Right, they could get a building permit to do something.
To do something that
and then come back
they wouldn't otherwise have been allowed to do.
I was thinking that, I agree with it. I think you may want to say it more strongly, because when I read it first, I'm like, well, that it doesn't seem like it's saying we don't think that it should be.
I agree.
The new date.
I agree. So we should word that more strongly.
We're giving them advice. They can tell us that they don't agree with it.
But this is totally advisory.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. We're listening to you know, that's what we try to explain to people is that, you know, we want your comments, you know. We want to hear from you. You know, a lot of people keep saying, well, you know, you don't pay attention, you know, why are we talking about that? That's not the truth at all. You know, I tell people, you know, if you have an opinion, you know, come to the meeting, voice your opinion. You know, granted, not every time, you know, it may not work out to the way we might want to hear it. I mean, we have to go by, you know, what's presented to us, what the law is, you know, and sometimes people, you know, they don't understand it, but you know, still come and voice your opinion. I mean, no one's going to get turned away. We're not going to tell you to sit down and don't want to hear from you. You know, so that's the main thing that, you know, I try to convey to everybody is, you know, if there's going to be a hearing and you're in a butter, and even if you're not in a butter, if you have an opinion, you know, let's hear it. So.
Yeah, so I'm just trying to think of how to...
Are we trying to say that which opinion do we want to
go with? So the last sentence here, the planning board expressed caution that the latter interpretation could lead to potential abuse by providing an effective end run around this. So instead of express caution, do we want to...
So I'm thinking of different words. Of
the planning board...
Anticipates or would expect that...
Is concerned is...
Yeah. Is concerned is probably better.
Okay. The planning board is concerned...
Is terrified?
...that the latter interpretation... provides an effective end run.
And then original, use that phrase, the legal phrase again at the end of that sentence. The last word on the front page.
Oh. The planning board is concerned that the latter interpretation, the...
Original.
Oh, the original structure.
Is as of the petition filing date. And throws.
Yes.
Is.
Yeah.
Yes.
And then I think that's, I like that.
Okay.
And it's a tougher interpretation. It was written as original, but it also, the other big item was that it's also supposed to be a subordinate portion, clearly subordinate part of a single family dwelling.
Yeah.
And when it's even close to half the square footage,
right.
It's not.
Well, that was their problem, and it's not, and it's all outside of the existing.
So that's why I was thinking they were going to go for a variance, because they were going to overcome that as a variance, because they can't. I can't see them meeting it under the special permit standard.
I have a hard time kind of justifying it either way, to be honest.
Yeah. Well, yeah, right.
You know.
But they have to ask for a variance because it isn't
because there's nothing conforming.
Yeah.
And it's not the 10% increase of the original structure.
Do we have that in this letter?
10% part?
Yeah, it clearly, yep, that's right. Clearly a subordinate part.
We may want to, I don't know if we want to highlight that as being the, we put the most important ones first.
Yeah.
And then the others follow.
Yeah. Yeah, so how would we rank those then, do you think, to strengthen
them? Clearly a subordinate part is kind of the biggest key.
Yeah. So let's move that up.
Because the intent of the bylaw when we drafted it was to have the big old houses in town to be able to use some of the rooms that aren't being used as apartments or as in-law accessible apartments. And if you needed to pump out to put a little entryway or a little bump out for something, that was what the 10% referenced. It wasn't rebuilding your garage and going up.
Without.
Which it seems clear when you read that bylaw that's it wasn't intended to cover, I think, this kind. Now, that said, they did mention at the meeting that I think they said long-term their intention is to do something with the original part of the house, tear it down and rebuild.
A two-story house. But just talking real quick about the zoning, the bylaw itself, I guess it's like Vinny said, and I agree with him, is, you know, how you interpret it. Basically, it seems to me is that after reading it a few more times, it basically seems that accessory apartment was put into place to help elderly people who lived in a house that got too big for them, and so they wanted some extra income to come in, okay? And in this particular situation, if you look at the bylaw and you look what the petitioner is trying to do, he's not making any money off of this, okay? He's not renting it to his parents. They're only gonna be here for 4 or 5 months, you know, and then they're gonna go back to, you know, to Florida. So it's, and I agree with Vinny, it's kind of a situation where it's, you know, it's, you know, I don't understand how that, because like I said, you know, it's what, considering taking into what he's trying to do and what the bylaw says, okay, it doesn't seem like he really even needs to come before the board. As long as he, you know, maintains it as a one family house. You know, it's just like, you know, somebody said, you know, well, you know, supposedly you can only have one kitchen in the house.
Right.
That's not true, because there's nothing in the state bylaw or in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts in the building code that says that a person can't have more than one kitchen in the house. You know.
What about the?
So, and the reason I know this is because I started thinking about this, and I'm thinking, you know what? When my grandmother was alive, she lived with my aunt and uncle, and they had a full kitchen in the basement, and that's where she used to make all her pastries and, you know, get all her special cooking and stuff. So, and after conversing with the building inspector, he basically said the same thing, because Ernie Park Jr., he put a second kitchen in his basement. The people complained about it, went to court and won his case.
Well, in this case, I know that there was a letter from the building inspector that said that what you're proposing is essentially a multifamily. You have to go to the ZBA to get permission for this. I can't grant you permission.
Right. And that's
on the record.
Right. And that's the difference between what you're saying is, I mean, the Italian background, you have a second kitchen downstairs in the basement, but a kitchen is fine. Having a second bathroom is fine. Having a bedroom in the basement is fine. But when you put that all together and create a separate living space, that makes it another residence, basically. So
yeah, I understand that. But the thing is if, but basically, okay, and maybe I'm misunderstanding the bylaw. Because basically, how I'm reading the bylaw is that a person is asking for an accessory apartment because they want to make extra income to help support the house.
Yeah, no, I don't read it as extra income.
No.
It was more to support the family member. So one of the things that we talked about was if when a family member gets elderly,
And whether it's one or two, or like the father passes away, the mom's still around, but the mom can't really do it by herself. The kids, well, yeah. One of the families would move into the main part of the house. The owner, being the mom, would move into the accessory apartment. That was what we were kind of thinking of, that thing. Or when the kids come back from school and you make a temporary accessory apartment.
But that means that they pay.
No, there's no paying involved. They're just living with them.
The language of that sentence that talks about the paying says, provide an opportunity for the older homeowners who can no longer physically or financially. So it might be physically, like you're saying, you have to help them do whatever.
Or financially.
It doesn't say that it has to be financial.
It doesn't say it's anything.
And it's because...
No, it doesn't limit it to only financial ones. You know,
but
it could be others.
But it's also saying that it seems to me that the bylaw is saying that somebody is actually going to be living there all the time.
Yeah, honestly.
You know, I mean, I understand, you know, the bylaw, and this is why at the last meeting, I made a suggestion to the board, and I'm hoping that eventually it's going to be looked at, is that I think this is a bylaw that really needs to be reviewed again. It was something that was set up 30-some-odd years ago, so things have changed over 30 years, you know, and, I think it's something that needs to be reevaluated.
I think one thing that is important to keep in mind in this situation is that this bylaw really is addressing structural issues. It doesn't say anything about what you can or cannot use your house for so much as it is you can't have structurally, essentially, two independent living spaces. And so, I mean, that's why it's going to the building inspector.
That's probably why he balked at this, because it is just a breezeway connecting the two.
It's a...
Right, and that's what I was thinking of adding in that sentence. Go back to this one specifically, where we talk about it being a subordinate part.
Yeah.
I wanted to add something in there, that the underlying zoning is a single residence district. So
what is being proposed
can easily be, or could easily be considered a duplex. Because you've got one house or one unit up above the garage, which is about the same size as the unit that's to the left of the garage on the other side of the breezeway. And they share a garage, or they share the breezeway.
That's right, that's in four.
I do have one question. I don't know
single family residence character.
So this garage was built last year. So do we consider this existing building? That's the thing, I don't know whether you guys...
Well, that's what he was saying in his letter.
Yeah, the letter has
the interpretation of that.
Both
the last paragraph. Yeah. We talked about that.
Yeah, it seems to be a matter of interpretation.
That's what
if you interpret it that the structure is as of the petition filing date, that's potentially problematic and provides a way to essentially get around the bylaw.
How do we interpret it?
ZBA has the say.
Yeah. Well, I mean, because you could say, okay, it's 5 years prior or 2 years prior or when you bought the property.
That's right. Not anywhere in the
I don't know what you can do with
it. That's not in the Bible.
No, that's why it's an interpretation.
No, but it
comes down to what do you think was intended by this bylaw when it was put into place? Do you think they intended it to allow people to put up a big garage and then, you know, turn that into a second apartment? Or do you think people intended it to maintain the single residence character of the neighborhood?
Existing house. That's how I...
Existing when they think about it, or existing when they bought it?
The house is already existing. It's been for many, many years. So they want to move into the basement. This one clearly says he has the intent in his head, so he want to build it so that he can make a nursery apartment. The garage was humongous, so that was his intention to make that kind of a garage.
I don't even know. It sounded like when he was talking at the meeting, his intention was to build this thing and then move into it, regardless of accessory apartments, and then rebuild his other house.
That's going to be a long, long way, whether he could or he, you know.
Well, it sounded like that's what he was thinking about until his parents needed to move in. That's what it sounded like.
But then you look at it from a different perspective too, okay? So he goes before the ZBA disapproves his, you know, I'm just speculating. They disapproved his, you know, accessory apartment, okay? Now, according to, there's no state law that says he can't put a kitchen up there, okay? And there's really, as long as it gets inspected and everything else, once he gets that kitchen in and it's inspected by the building inspector, the gas inspector, the plumbing inspector, the electrical inspector, there's nothing to say that he can't put a bedroom up there, you know, in a bathroom. I mean, how would anybody know? I mean...
Inspect it again.
So the thing is, you know, if ever it will be, if ever if inspected, then they find it, there is a necessary apartment, then he will be get fined without ZBA's approval.
Well, but then it's interpretation
again. There are people are saying there are so many accessory apartments out there without proper ZBA approval. But if somebody complained, the building inspector goes and see they said there is an accessory apartment, then there would be a fine, right?
Well, there could be. I mean, I think that's the way it goes, but when there's an accessory apartment, a lot of the times it's advertised when it's up for sale. So the value, I mean, if you want to put in a kitchen and all sorts of other things into your house, you're, like I said, you're welcome to do that. But once it becomes more of a duplex, if it's in a single residence district, then that's in violation of zoning.
Could that be done? In other words,
you're supposed to have deed riders when, if you approve an accessory apartment, there's
but it's supposed to evaporate anyhow.
And they're supposed to be submitting a draft to you. Or they're supposed to have a deed rider. We recommended that they, that you, the ZBA, get the deed rider wording from them before you close a public hearing, so that you can actually read it and make sure that it says what you want, instead of closing the public hearing and say, well, this is what we want to use, and since there's no more public information to be presented, that's what you're stuck with. So get all the paperwork before you close the public hearing and have their attorney do it, and that way it doesn't cost the town to do any review.
The only piece of paper, the only thing that's required for us to get from them at the hearing is the notarized letter that says that the owner of the property will be physically living in the house. It's not until after it's approved that they have to go to the registry of deeds and do, get it on the registry. And then they have to bring a copy of that sealed with the seal on it to the zoning board.
Right, so, but what if that, what they get recorded is not what the zoning board of appeals believes to be acceptable? They already recorded it and you're done. That's why the ZBA should get draft, approve the wording, and then have it executed. Like we do with our, we do it with the homeowners associations. We do it with, in the site plan review, if there's some other limitations. They have to submit whatever documents they're gonna send to the registry. We approve the format, and then they execute it, get it recorded, and then we get the copy still.
And that's why I think that this bylaw needs to be reviewed. And I think that what you're bringing up is a valid point, but it should be all, that information should be in the bylaw. So that the ZBA, because you know the thing, it all boils down to this: we're all, you know, volunteers, and there has been absolutely minimal training, and we're finding out by me going to these other meetings of other boards, I'm finding out that there are things that the ZBA should be doing that we're not be, not that we're not doing because nobody ever told us that we needed to do this, you know. So I mean. It's really kind of a difficult situation.
That's why you have the town council to consult on.
What's that?
That's why we have the town council to talk to
get the consultation. But the thing was that when the former town administrator was here, his policy was is that if a board had a question about town, it had to go through the chair. The chair then had to go to the, and then the town administrator made the decision on whether it was going to be worth to call town council. It's not like I can just pick up the phone and call town council and say, hey, look, you know. So, I mean, you know, fortunately we got some training next week from town council about special permits, variances, and the open meeting law, okay? Hopefully within the next month or two, we're gonna have Mass House Partnership coming in to give us training, the ZBA training on 40B projects, comprehensive permits, and so forth, you know. And that's because I talked to someone from Mass Housing who happened to be.
Oh yeah, we have to announce that at this meeting too.
We'll get there.
So, okay.
So in our letter.
What's that?
In our letter, we're gonna go back to.
Yes.
Do we want to include something about not having it become a duplex?
You mean in the deed?
No.
Oh,
no, no, no. Under that same being subordinate part, we never finished up on that.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be a subordinate, clearly a subordinate part of the single family dwelling. As proposed, the planning board, and disagree with me if you think so, but the planning board sees this proposal as almost a duplex.
Or even worse, because it's just a breezeway. It's not even a duplex, which is attached, you know?
Well, but still, that would meet the standard for attached, that they make duplexes with just a breezeway.
Just a breezeway?
Yeah.
Okay, then a duplex.
So that is, that means, you know, so if they have a, if they have a house that is in another different structure, if it is an accessory apartment, so they cannot put a breeze, they cannot connect it to the.
Well, it's a single residence, it should only be one structure.
But when you connect.
Unless you're Chris's neighbor.
No, when you connect it with the. When you connect it with the breezeway.
That makes
so
it.
So that becomes a single unit?
It's one, that makes it one structure.
Yeah.
So that this is also one structure, right?
Yeah,
I'm
just saying.
It's one structure. But if it has two living spaces in it, then that becomes a duplex.
So, same thing. The big house is there. There is another small shed kind of a thing. So that, can I use it as an accessory apartment and connect it?
Yeah. Yeah, they've actually
done
so
that. That's the point of what we're saying in this letter.
And it's been done in the past. They've actually put in a trellis to connect a house to a barn structure.
Yes, that's
and
the same question.
So that isn't two habitable dwellings anymore. Having that trellis and a little roof associated with the trellis makes it a single building.
So if you connect it, it becomes a single building.
It's a structure, a single structure, yes. Luckily this guy isn't trying to play the games that way, so that's a good thing, but
there is one the size of the, is there different. Is one other issue maybe coming to the board, that's why.
On a different property?
Different property.
Okay.
So they were
let's get through this letter first.
All right, so with the subordinate stuff, I'll include stuff about the single residence and can be considered a duplex.
I'll throw something together.
Could you say something as dangerous as opposed to being a duplex?
Awesome.
You got to learn to delegate like Mark.
I'll show you. And deflect more work.
I need help, yes, please. Thank you.
And shortly I'll comment about what it needs to say in the.
That's
in
there. Actually, I was just reading the bylaw. It's so important in the bylaw. There's a section, transfer of ownership of dwelling with an accessory apartment. There's number one is something. Number two is the, upon receiving special permit, the owners must file with the Worcester County Registry of Deeds. But number four is identical. So it's listed twice.
It's all right. We could correct it.
That's how important it is.
Twice.
And that's the declaration.
Did you comply with two and four, or only two?
For you to interpret.
All right. So, any other changes to the letter people want to propose, or does that seem?
What's the word you're using down there?
Sufficient.
Is concerned.
Is concerned.
Is excited.
Planning board is concerned.
I like your
word
terrified.
Is terrified. Terrified and excited. Concerned.
Not
good.
That,
I mean, it gets
that letter will go to all of us.
I send it to the ZBA email.
Yeah.
Not just Christina. Yeah. I stand.
Yeah, sounds good.
All right. Next.
Do you want a copy? I'll give you my draft.
No, we need to get the whole thing set.
Oh, you want
to? All right, so we've done the A&R. This one real quick. We did get an email back from, I think it was the town administrator, that we need a new nominee. From the Planning Board for Economic Development Task Force, because
there's three planning
three
board of selectmen
members on there. If we don't, so
that seems like it's got you written all over it.
Nominate Mark.
I will go on to it if nobody else wants to. Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Mark.
No problem.
Sorry. That's what I'm talking about. Stepping up and taking one for the board. Good man, good man. All right, moving on.
Were there more ZBA things, or is that all?
There are. There's two others, but they're later down.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Sorry.
Yeah, there was an amendment to the original agenda. CMRPC Community Development Block Grant. There's an email that I received from CMRPC. I think I forwarded it to the board. I think the more I looked into it, it had to do with low, moderate income incentive things and eliminating blight in neighborhoods. It didn't look to me like it necessarily applied to towns like ours. But
well, the only place we used that was Century Farm down Fountain Street. It was a blighted area, a blighted open space. But we got the money from the state, and so we cool. built the road, so it worked out.
Great.
I don't know many other sites like that right now.
I'm not aware.
Could it be used in Oakdale? I mean, not Oakdale. The housing...
Orchard Knoll?
Orchard Knoll. I mean, that could use some money always.
It's possible. I mean, I don't... It's a lot of paperwork.
It did stress that it was very heavy administratively, a lot of work. It stressed that they're very competitive. So, you know, if you apply, there's no guarantee. Certainly,
it's years.
Yeah.
It's not a quick turnaround.
Yeah.
It's only the ATM.
Right.
Okay.
It's not like DLTA, unfortunately.
Yeah.
That we've used in the past.
Don't go there. That's
All right. Moving on. Discussion of the special town meeting from this past Monday. I don't know if anybody had any comments. I personally was satisfied with the outcome.
Yeah. I also.
Yeah, we saw that.
You should call me or text me, reminder.
We had enough people. I was expecting a 15-minute meeting, but yeah. It went longer. But it was...
Oh, why, Cheryl didn't come?
No, I completely forgot. She could have called me.
They did well. It worked out.
Yeah. We were okay.
That was the most important thing.
But
I was at home.
So I would expect very soon, since they want to start very soon, that we would be getting a site plan review package, or at least some kind of a preliminary thing.
Well, they said there was a meeting in September with the state, so they may be
waiting for that, maybe.
But I think that's a done deal.
Okay.
So they may be coming quickly as well, yeah.
Great. Great.
I nominate Phil from Angel Brook to do their drainage checks.
That's right.
Good idea.
He'll be all over
if
that.
I could second that, I would.
Finland,
Carl. All right, very good. So let's move on to the last two items, the other two draft ZBA letters, if we can.
Yep. Flag.
There is, I think, yeah.
Why don't mine say to sign off if okay? Did I grab your
flag? I think you're the clerk now, aren't you?
Okay, but that one changed. But they're from you, Chris Olson.
I'm the clerk.
No, because I told you, Chris.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, I'm getting confused.
Well, you're going to sign it. You've got it by mistake.
Don't worry about it.
It was almost delivered to my house, I think.
Don't worry about it.
Okay. Yeah. I think it almost got delivered to us.
All right, so let's take a look at the Flag RV 0 West Boylston Street special permit for, sales and storage of motor vehicles, RV units. Across West Boylston Street from where they're currently located. We received as a board, one of the neighbors sent an email to us asking what was going on with the trees being cut down there. And
oh, that's what that one was?
Yes, that's what that was. I corresponded back with her a couple of times.
Two city states?
No, actually, it was the woman at the house just to the right.
Oh, okay.
There's
a
Bank
small
of America?
House.
Borders
the plaza.
She's complaining about the other side.
Oh, she's got it on one side already.
She loved the trees. She was sad to see them go, and she was wondering what was going on.
Okay.
So I just mentioned to her that this, you know, that there's the ZBA hearing next week, and she's.
But they can clear the.
She's sure to attend. I mean, I think people can clear their land without permission.
It has happened in the past. That's what goes on. That's why in our bylaws, which we had a little problems with on the Cumberland Farms folks,
mm-hmm.
when we look at the drainage, if someone
has a property that's wooded, and they go and they strip the whole thing down, rip up all the grass, they can't come in with their drainage plans and say, oh, this is all just a dirt area, so there's not that much runoff. So in our bylaws, we said that it has to be in a developed or an undeveloped state is the way you do your drainage calculations.
Yeah.
Because we accepted the fact that someone can cut all the trees off their property if they want.
Yeah.
They're allowed to do that.
Okay, but that can impact their, that has drainage implications.
So when they, when this site, if it ever comes in as a site plan review, they're going to have to design their drainage to
so their baseline address, will be different.
Yeah, the baseline will be a full wooded area, even though they cut all the trees.
So is
if
that,
the planning board sticks to it for a change.
So is they're going to have to
flag it. Flag's okay. Well, so that's one of the that was one of the points in the letter was if they're putting in 15 or more spaces, then that would be
we
a trigger for SBR.
Right. A use that requires 15 or more spaces.
Yeah.
They don't have to put the actual spaces in, but if the use
yep.
triggers it.
Yep.
But one thing, just to clarify something, one thing that everybody needs to understand is that Flag RV is not the one that's asking for the special permit.
It was
Flag RV is not.
It was Mara P. Flag.
Okay, she. They heard.
She's the applicant.
Is that the right name?
Petition is
Marino.
I couldn't read the.
Yeah, it's
M A R I N O.
No. It's Marino. M A R I N O.
No, Chris. It's M A R I N O.
Yeah.
It's M A R.
You.
That's the.
You didn't emphasize the I.
They had it wrong.
See, now I'm confused.
So
that's Michael?
That's who we're going to be.
So I need to change that. It's not.
The thing was is that what I.
Sorry, M-A-R-O. No, don't change it. It's M-A-R-O.
M-A-R-O?
M-A-R-I. No.
Because it's. There's three Marinos.
There's M-A-R-O. M-A-R-O.
But then.
We got it.
I got it right
here. M-A-R-O.
Can I say
M-A-R-O?
Rose Marino, trustee. Care of the Westford Group.
Oh, there's Marino.
In Concord, Mass.
Marino.
Rose M. Marino.
Right, M-A-R-I-N-O.
Yep.
And then her sons are on there, Michael, Vincent, and Brian.
Michael V. and Brian, yeah.
Okay, now one thing that was specified was that they need to be here because they are the owners of the property. They're the ones that are requesting
okay.
The special permit. What's going to happen is that if the board decides to give them the special permit, then Flag RV is going to lease the property from them for I think it's a period of 6 months until their new building on their property is built.
So what's the bylaw they're falling under for this special permit?
I think it's the, in that way, did I mention in there that it wasn't specified?
You should have gotten something from the building inspector.
Well,
no. Well their petition,
the petition.
Yeah, it says right here, it's blank. They left that part blank.
Yeah,
okay.
It's a name.
But it appears that they're looking for business use, where is it? Right here. F-18, outdoor sales, such as motor vehicle or recreation vehicles, in the business district requires a special permit from the ZBA. Under the schedule of use. So that's what I was basing the letter on, since it doesn't
say that too
in the petition.
Did you say that?
I did.
See, they cleared the land, but we have no idea exactly what they're doing to the land.
Right.
Are they grading it? Are they going to use stone? Are they going to pave it? You know, how many trailers are they going to use? Are they going to
assess the drainage?
Yeah, you know, all of that.
Would
and the thing is, if they're just leasing the property to RV, to Flag, in 6 months, when Flag gets back into the new building, now you have a piece of property that's empty.
But maybe Flag is Marina.
No.
They're not.
Do you know that?
Who?
Marinos?
No, they live in Concord.
If they say they're going to use less than 15 spaces to avoid site plan,
yeah.
Does drainage become an issue?
You're not allowed under what is the rule? You can't worsen drainage onto anyone on your abutting property.
No matter what you do.
Right.
Because then the abutters.
Because that property sits above where Alfornos is.
It sits above everything.
So this special permit.
Yeah, property's up there.
Didn't I do one of these, a special permit? Because the special permit reflects a bunch of standards that are required to issue a special permit.
Yep.
And you, did you use those or 5.3D?
5.3D. It requires a buffer because they're next to a residential district behind them.
Yes, which.
So I mentioned that.
Right, and I think that was good.
Yep.
But then there's, what else? Yeah, so I wrote plenty, such a petition from the ZBA is to be reviewed under the standard set forth in section 6.2E1 and 6.2E4.
Can you send that an email with that?
Oh, that's 5.3.
The what?
5.3 is the screening one.
Yeah.
The standards for special permit from the ZBA is 6.2E.
That's it. Special permits.
E1 and E4 are what apply.
After public hearing, only where such conditions and safeguards required have been made, and the only exception for such grant would be the health, welfare, safety, comfort, or convenience of the community should not be adverse. So you have to look at traffic circulation for safety, drainage. For health or public health, are they going to have a sandy can out there?
What? Bathroom.
What are they doing for bathrooms?
Porta potty.
I mean, this is all the stuff we look at in the site plan review, which I think they're trying to bypass that, and so the ZBA is going to get stuck with having to do basically a site plan review.
You can impose your. Your guidelines there, and you could get. Could you get VHB on a special permit?
If it's in their policy or guidance, they would have someone to review. But I don't know. They don't have a plan to review.
Yeah.
So it's just. For the would actually be requesting a plan of the layout. How many vehicles? How are they going to be aligned? What's the traffic pattern? Where's the parking for clients or visitors, whatever they're asking?
Because they're not going to walk across.
They better not. That's public safety. Well, they might be imposing that.
Kind of asinine, I would think.
I think they're going to drive their golf cart across.
We already know crosswalks are frowned upon on Route 12.
On Route 12.
So that's not an option.
Except for on Franklin Street,
the one that goes across. The new one, right at the end of the street here.
Right where the traffic is
the worst.
DOT said that it's okay. They don't have a problem.
Did they say that?
Yeah, on the sidewalk thing.
Yeah.
On the sidewalk ends out here, and it doesn't go anywhere unless the sidewalk gets it, or the crosswalk gets it across the street.
Right. To where?
Otherwise, we have to pay a change fee to turn the sidewalk into Surfside's parking lot. But then it just went to Surfside's parking lot. Sorry, I'm reading now.
All right, so.
So can you just.
We're going to write something.
Okay, and then send it to me. Okay, I'll send it to the board.
Send it to the board.
Okay.
So I'll write something again with this. So
awesome. Thank you.
So, I forgot what I was saying.
Taking one for the board, just like Mark did earlier. I appreciate it.
Well, you've been doing a lot. I don't want to run you out. You've got a couple of years left as chair.
Chris left his last year.
That sounds good. And to your point, those other issues are really to help the ZBA evaluate that standard that you just highlighted in E1, 6.2E1.
Yeah, we did. Yes.
Perfect.
E, postscript E, E1 and E4.
Did I send these out as Word documents and not as PDF hopefully?
I think so.
PDF. I think so.
Okay. Let me know if I didn't.
I think the E4 talks about everything they're supposed to do.
Yeah.
E4, A or B.
It's everything.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Ingress and egress as opposed to vehicles and pedestrian traffic.
Oh, that's right, too.
Yeah.
That's in there.
Yep.
Create danger, pollution, public, private water facilities.
Yeah, because I actually use this. Yep. I use the standard for the gold cellar over down in Oakdale. I'll use that same format from that letter that I wrote once before.
Awesome. Sounds good.
Oh, if they are going to leave it,
and
not
pay anymore. Remember the across from where Laurel Street comes down?
We'll make a sales lot.
Yeah, you wanted to do that.
Use car. Car.
So I'll use the same wording and be consistent.
He's never come back.
Yeah.
And the reason being was is that come to find out that the land is actually his wife's. She was the one that was supposed to submit the special permit, not him. And he knew that and said, okay, fine. And supposedly, I was under the impression that he was gonna do it
and come back. Yeah.
He's never come back. So that's why when I talked to Toby about this, I said, please make sure that Marino or somebody from that represents that trust is at the meeting, because the property is in the trust name. They're the ones that are the ones that have to file for the special permit. What they do once they get it, well, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And what we just learned from the Sarabian experience is he can't get a notarized letter saying that the owner has authorized them to speak for them.
Yeah.
Because that didn't seem to work out so good.
Right.
We should.
Good point.
There's a lot of these in the section E4.
Yes.
You know, there's things about
satisfaction arrangement. It's more clear, right.
I mean, it's got a lot of these requirements. Stuff about if they're going to leave the dust or other pollution that'll affect the neighbors. No excessive noise, vibration, glare, dust, smoke, heat shall be observable at the lot lines. Satisfactory arrangement to refuse disposal for the refuse disposal.
When people submit
site plans,
it's there.
The use shall be in general compatible with harmony.
You, how specific do you require them to?
We have a site plan review standard and application package.
Okay.
This is what we're looking for.
Because it seems to me that in this situation and other situations, it doesn't seem like when people are submitting for a special permit, it doesn't seem like we're not getting, at least in my opinion, we're not getting a lot of information. Like this here, it's just, you know, this is, we're going to use it for a sales lot and a business, you know, business office, and that's it. There's nothing else. There's nothing that tells me, you know, what they're going to do, how many parking spaces they're going to have, you know, are they going to have a party
right.
thing there, you know, are they going to have place, you know, parking spots for potential customers,
right.
you know, and now you're saying that it could be...
Because in the site plan review bylaw, there's a section of this is what the package should include.
Okay.
I don't know...
Well, this
really has
this is what you guys have to go by.
Yeah.
I mean, as a ZBA, when someone comes with a site plan review, you go back to, what is it, page 91, section 62E4, and it gives you the whole list of all the stuff that you're supposed to be doing.
Okay. So if you write it up and send it to us, that would be greatly appreciated.
Yep.
And to that point, lean on VHB or whoever the engineer. I mean, let them do that work for you. You know.
What engineer?
Well, if you're doing a site plan review, your guidelines that you can.
They're not really doing a site plan review. They're doing a review of these things.
Oh.
So
okay.
What you want to do is want to throw the burden on the applicant, the petitioner, I want all this information, and if you don't get it. You continue the hearing until you get that information.
I mean, you don't have to do all the work in your, you know, yourself. That's what I learned.
Yeah.
You can give it to them.
Right,
you know?
They have the burden.
Yeah. They're the one that's going to make the money on it, you know, so make them do the work.
Yeah, that's good.
All right, you want to move on to the third letter then?
I'm afraid to.
No, I think this is going to be quick.
Let's hope so.
Let's hope so.
It is very good. I actually, I liked it.
263 Maple Street.
Oh, no, that one.
Yes.
I have to recuse myself, don't I?
Is DCR?
Yeah. Oops. Are they abutting the back? Because the DCR bought the back portion.
I think so.
Yeah. Well, that makes it easy for the rest of us. Yeah, it sounds really
You're right, we'll be quick.
Yeah, it sounds really good and I like it.
All right, well, that one's done.
No, actually, I thought it was well worded and I sure agree that that would be the, you're right, I didn't think of it at the time, but we did not have the details of the municipal services at the time.
Yeah.
I think that was a good
one. That came right out of the bylaws, so I just wanted to highlight.
Yeah, no, that was perfect.
So what are you proposing?
What are we proposing? We're saying essentially that this guy's looking to ask for, to reduce his frontage.
Right.
He's allowed to go to the ZBA to ask for a reduced frontage. The difficult part is that that part of the bylaw says that the reduced frontage in single residence can't, or in a residential district, isn't allowed to go below 100 feet.
Right.
Well, right now he's at just over 100 feet.
Right.
He's asking to remove the portion that's about 40 feet.
Right.
So we go down to about 65. What do I have here?
Yeah, 65.
66.3 feet. Yeah. But so in one sense he's in violation of that part of the rule that he would no longer have frontage of a minimum of 100 feet. So if you read it that way, that suggests the ZBA can't grant that special permit because that distances below 100 violate the rule that's set forth there. However, given this situation, it's an irregular lot, right? There's two different points of, you know, frontage, one of 66, one of 40 feet. And given that the currently existing access is with respect to that 66-foot portion. So if you were, and because it's irregular, if you want to say that maybe there's motivation to remove the irregularity, which is essentially what this proposal would do. It would get him back to, or get this lot back to one portion that only has, you know,
one
area of frontage. Albeit it would be below 100, but in one sense, it would be making the lots at least more regular in shape.
Did you guys actually get a copy of the map?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Because, no, not that one, the other one.
There's another one that came here.
This one?
This one right here. Okay. What happened was, from what I understand, I don't understand why this is not included, but these two are on opposite side of this.
Yeah.
Right.
What he wants to do is, from what I gather, is take this property line and move it this way.
No.
I'll move it this way.
He wants to move this property line to here.
Right. But so now, but what is, so he doesn't own this land?
No.
Okay. But how did it get approved that it's, that he had, now I thought the frontage was supposed to be continuous. No?
It doesn't have, it's not specified in the bylaw that it has to be continuous. At least that I'm aware of.
So in other words, you can have a huge piece of property, have 50 feet over here, then have a house over here, then have another piece, then another
if you look at what this used to look like, his frontage was over here, and his driveway was over here. That's how we got around it before. And then he broke this all off, gave it to DCR. I mean, that's how screwy it can get as far as this whole frontage rules. I mean, but this was a long time ago. They already did this, and maybe we shouldn't have done that. But
okay, so now he's getting rid of this 40 feet, and so now his entrance is only going to be 65 feet.
Right.
It's only ever been 65 feet. That's all he's ever used.
And that's all he's ever used.
But it was, yes, but he was adding this and this.
And previously this.
Right. No, but I mean, this is what it was, according to what I was told. This was what he was considered his frontage, and he was over the 100 feet.
Yep.
Okay, but now he's taken this away, and that's only going to be this frontage, which is now below
the 100 feet.
100 feet. So,
okay.
Well, I mean, the letter doesn't say we think you should do this.
the letter suggests that, you know, there, again, there's a matter of interpretation with that part of the bylaw. One interpretation is the frontage here will be below 100, you're not entitled to the special permit. A different interpretation is this is an atypical situation.
Well,
and because it's atypical and it's functionally not affecting access at all. And because of that, the ZBA might see fit to go ahead and grant the special permit. It's an issue of interpretation.
So the ZBA can grant a special permit, even if the zoning says that the frontage has to be 100 feet or more.
The ZBA is always going against zoning.
I'm saying that the ZBA has in its power to interpret the bylaws. It's a question of interpretation.
Well, and there's a part of the ZBA rules that say they're there to allow people to build on land that's hard, that's got ledge, or that's got strange configurations and things like that. I mean, that's why the ZBA is around, for some strange land, whatever,
that's a variance.
Features. That's a variance.
Not a
special permit. Ugh. Fine, don't do it.
So would this be considered a variance and not a special permit?
I mean, that's something you could bring up.
It's a good
why
thing
couldn't
that,
you do it?
It's a good thing that
in this situation.
Coming Monday instead of Thursday, you know, before our meeting. So I guess these are the questions that we can ask.
So what is he going to do with this lot?
That's
going to
be his new property line.
But where he's going to?
It's going to be owned by this guy.
Oh, that's to the DCR.
No,
to the next neighbor.
So he's going to give it.
It's the back of his property that he donated to DCR.
Oh, so he is giving this land to
that piece.
The next.
Is he giving it to DCR or is he giving it to the people next door?
No, the small piece.
This all used to be one big piece of property, okay?
Yeah.
There's another piece over here.
Yeah.
What he did was, is he's
right
giving
here.
This property to this, but the land that he had back here, over here somewhere, he
all
gave
this.
To DCR. Yeah, he gave to DCR. Oh,
what is he going to do, this one? This side, this area? The
that's
entire
going
area is going to go to the next door?
Yes, this is all going to this person over
that
here.
That person, not DCR.
Right, no, this person over here. All of this whole little
right.
square right here.
Again, this becomes like an irregular thing, right?
No, then their thing, their lot actually looks better. Because they got this sort of triangle, and now they got a triangle that's a little bit flat.
Yeah, here, you know, this will come like here, right?
Yeah. Right, so I mean, their lot gets a little bit more property on it, and it's a little bit flagged. But nothing, I mean, not much worse than they got right now.
But it's not a U-shape anymore.
Well, this guy, the new priest
right,
property.
Right,
right. The one over
yes,
here, it's taking it
that
out.
One also, you know.
It gets to be a little bit more frontage.
It's a little more frontage. It's
yeah, but this will become like this, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Again, this goes like this.
Yep, that's a new piece of property on that side.
Okay, good.
Well, there's nothing wrong with that piece of property. That, whatever frontage that thing's got, it gets more. Right now he's got... Oh, he's got 135 now. So he adds 40 to that.
Yeah.
So he's good.
All right, so what do people think about any amendments to this letter? I mean, get rid of paragraphs altogether, change nothing. What do you guys think?
I like the letter.
I like the letter.
I like that, you know, the suggestion you make. Do we want to suggest maybe it has to switch to a variance or instead of a special permit?
Could propose that as an alternative.
I mean, or do we want to go that far? You know, I mean, because if you go to all the way to variance, then you're letting them say that's I don't even know what the topography looks like, but it could be due to the land itself, which is really what the variance is for. You know.
That's why we elected you.
Why?
You're on it. That's good.
I mean, you know, if there's a hill or something, I don't know, a river, I don't know, that separates him from the other half of his property. So that's why he wants to give it to the person who it's contiguous with. That's like a real, I don't know, land issue, which is what a variance is about.
I think it was all trees and bushes and...
It probably was, I mean.
All right, so I can add something about, you know, an alternative.
Potential.
Path forward is to seek a variance.
And I think that gives you a little bit more leeway as the ZBA, so you're not special permitting away the 100 feet, you know, you're variancing away the 100 feet for, you know, or better, I don't know, I think it gives you a little more authority because it's a variance to do weird things.
And there's more that they have to provide to prove that about a variance.
They have to do all the variance stuff.
Right.
It's actually, I think, less. I mean, you know, they just have to show that the land prevents them from, I mean, it's difficult, but it's only the one thing. They got to prove the land doesn't let them do what they want to do.
And then you answered that woman's email. She had all those questions about property. Did you answer that email?
No. That one just came through, didn't it?
Yeah, it did. I thought you...
No, I haven't done anything with that. All right. So, all right, well, just to finish up on the letter, let me add something about the variance.
The, what is it?
Alternatively, if the ZBA finds a special permit standard has not been met, possible variance to assess,
land limitations or something like that.
Okay. Under the appropriate variance standard. Fair enough?
Yeah, although Beardsley, I don't know, he's probably done with this. I think he wanted to come to us just to get an A&R.
All right.
Do you want a copy of this?
So I will, I'll button that up and send that out. All right, now we want to talk about that email that we just got. This was from
a neighbor.
Julie HQ.
And she seemed to be inquiring as to sort of, she's noticed some changes. She wants to know what's going on, who owns what, that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
It seems like.
I
don't know how much of this stuff is sort of planning board issues.
The building inspector.
Yeah.
I told him to do that.
Oh, you did?
Good.
She's good.
Awesome.
Yeah, perfect. All right, done.
All right, where are we? Reports from other boards?
We have the emails.
Yeah, let's go through those. God, I did too much.
This is the 99 Hart Road.
Stop.
See the nurse below the... There's already 99 Hart Road.
No, it's over.
Oh, the latest one?
Yeah.
Yeah, that appears to be all set. All right, we talked about that. Mass DOT?
Yeah.
Writing in response to your previous correspondence regarding subject projects being Route 140, your favorite topic.
Awesome!
What do they have to say here?
Oh, they just, they call me too. I think they just says they're going on with the project.
Oh, they did? Not subject to Mass DOT's healthy transportation policy.
That's what she said, right?
That's what she said in the meeting.
Yeah.
The project would not preclude future improvements such as those you detailed in your correspondence. Project would be fairly complex. If interest, town should contact the district office to discuss the scope of improvements.
All right, Melanie?
What do you think? Is there a action item here?
No, they're going on with the drainage project.
Yeah. All right. Then we had the schedule for the town meeting, for the town warrant that was submitted.
I don't think we'll have an article this time around, will we? We don't have any draft bylaws, we don't have...
I don't think we have any.
I don't think so.
So were you going to do the, an amendment to one of the bylaws? Are you talking about...
Which one?
Me?
No.
Oh.
Raj.
Which one? I don't know which one.
It's late, but it's not that late.
What are you trying
to... You, Raj, was there one of the bylaws you wanted to get changed? Was there a noise bylaw you were thinking about introducing?
Oh, the Jake Break bylaw.
Jake Break, no. It was shut down.
So then nothing on October.
Fair enough.
For the Jake Break, you know, what they said is, so if you put a sign on that, no Jake Break, if there is an accident, and then the driver can turn around and blame the town, because no Jake Break, there is an accident.
Yeah, I'm still not clear on how they really...
That's what the explanation.
How they really
say... Then we just have to say no Jake Break and no accident.
They still have all their breaks.
Yes, exactly.
Jake Break is just an...
Exactly.
One
and I have seen other towns...
Yeah, I have seen it, too.
Where they say, you know, or like Jake Breaks, no Jake Breaks unless necessary, or no Jake Breaks, you know, that kind
so
of thing,
that was,
to soften it.
That was done.
I think just no Jake Breaks and no accidents.
They cannot say no Jake Break. They cannot use the word Jake.
Noise,
no. But they can use
no engine brake.
Yeah, engine brake.
And
noise.
That's a good definition to
so
it.
That they
just no noise. Noise. No noise.
So no noise.
No
at all.
Noise. No accidents.
Never pass that.
Turn your engine off.
No wake.
Yeah.
We
right.
can discuss that.
You want to do a draft? We can consider.
I'll look.
So we're not doing this. This meeting.
Is there a draft bylaw brewing here?
No.
I mean, we could try, but I don't think we could change an accessory apartment kind of bylaw by then.
No, we wouldn't have time for public hearings and drafts and all that.
There's lots of bylaws we should try.
Oh, really?
Oh. No, that was shut down.
Which one?
No, I was thinking of this, the abandoned properties, the bank-owned properties. Who will maintain?
Oh, that's a bylaw?
There is an ordinance in Worcester.
Oh, so we'd make a new one? Okay.
They don't want to do it.
All right, well, I mean, but this is actually a good, I mean, not just today for this meeting, but I think going forward, it would be helpful to keep thinking, you know, are there bylaw amendments that we might want to consider, even to address some of the typos that we've noticed over the years.
There was another one where they duplicated a whole section.
Yeah, exactly.
You know?
I mean, things
we
like...
We may want to keep a set. I think I might have...
Keep them running.
Just have knowing all the, like, things that are issues.
Yeah, and I know it mentioned something about, you know, abandonment 1 year, and I think by state law it's actually 2 years.
Yeah.
Do we have to revisit the site plan review?
Is that in the ZBA? I'm sorry.
No, the site plan review.
Which one?
Is there something that changed?
No.
No.
Oh, we were going to change the number of copies of something or other and digital copies required, like the requirements, or is that just in our guidelines?
Yeah, because it says on a floppy, I think.
Yeah, or something like that.
Yeah, for the
so that was one of those things came up.
That's a good point, too. Yeah.
You don't want it on a floppy?
No.
Well, they can send it on a floppy. I don't know what we'll do with it.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah, it's be an interesting agenda item to maybe... Keep a running.
Yeah, there is
item.
One other.
That'll be a long list.
That's a good idea for a meeting that stops. It might stop before 9.
Yeah, not tonight.
We should start it now.
Yeah,
agreed. All right. Minutes? Is that what we're up to now?
No, we got to do the staff
other
meetings.
Other boards. My apologies.
Other boards.
Other boards. Any other boards?
Yeah, I have something. I do.
Go ahead. You do.
Yeah, community preservation met this evening prior to this meeting, and the community preservation committee is trying to work with the Greater Worcester Land Trust in purchasing the Goodell Street property. They're calling it Malden Hill South, which is the former Dennis Minnick property. So what happened was the Greater Worcester Land Trust purchased it from Mr. Minnick, and now they're working with the Community Preservation Committee to have the Community Preservation Committee purchase the West Boylston land only. from the Greater Boylston Land Trust. So there was a meeting this evening to discuss that, and we'll have to have follow-up meetings about it. And it was really just to for the discussion part of it, and there hasn't been a formal request that has been made yet from the Greater Boylston Land Trust to the Community Preservation, but that will be coming.
Do you know how much land is we talking about? Is it an acre? Is it 10 acres?
You know what? They had a split.
A little over 12.
Yeah, 12, they had a split what was Holden and what was Boylston.
13 and a half in Holden. The property is right on the town line.
Yeah.
Is it right across from the Holy Cross spot?
Yes. Well,
I think it's near.
Towards Holden a little bit more. But yeah, because it's. But basically, it is right there. It's right on the line where 13 acres, a little over 13 acres, is in Holden. And it's the old Tajan's farm that's been kind of divvied up. So, but there's 12 acres in West Boylston. They were talking about it at the open space meeting. Mike Pekar is coordinating it with the Greater Boylston Land Trust. And it seems like he's doing a good job because if they've already bought it, so that's starting the protection. So that's good because there was an offer made on the property by a 40B developer. So
correct.
I think what? That's a good thing. Now we just have to get the process so that I think the town, they're going to ask for the town to acquire it from Greater Boylston Land Trust. I'm not sure who in the town, whether the Conservation Commission is going to run it or maintain and manage it. It may also be the water district, but it's not really close to the water.
Yeah, well, West Boylston really wants to purchase it first and then kind of decide afterwards, but just get it in our hands first and then have discussion after the fact about what.
So what are they planning to use that for?
Yeah, that's what I was just saying. So they haven't really had that final discussion about the plans for it. I think that Mike Pekar had stated that it would be his wish to have it as like walking trails or something like that for the people.
Elbow Cemetery.
No buildings.
You need the space.
Yeah, no buildings. A cemetery was not mentioned, but the way that West Boylston was looking at it was that they want to purchase the property first, and then the use of it would occur afterwards, because if West Boylston was owning it, then West Boylston would also have to come up with funds to, you know, develop trails and maintain it. And so that would be coming down the line, but it's really
put a giant turf multi-purpose field on it.
Good, yeah, sure.
Yeah, but do we need that?
How much would that cost?
The property? Do we need
the property is fine. Do we need to make a walking trail and other things?
No.
Well, trails don't take much.
Yeah, but we could make use of that as a cemetery.
That is a possibility. I'm not sure what the agreement that Greater Boylston Land Trust had with the in their purchase, because Greater Boylston Land Trust has limited development.
Right.
There's no buildings on a cemetery, so it might be an idea to do that. 12 acres would be nice, but I think there's a lot of ledge up there. It was pretty rocky, if I remember years ago when I walked it, and going up 190 on the sides where there's cut, it's pretty rocky, but it's an idea.
Yeah, so yeah, that part isn't happening yet, but they will be putting in an application to purchase the property with the community preservation monies. And then an application was also placed by the Affordable Housing Trust for $25,000.
What'd you say?
So far, we approved it. Approved $25,000 because they want to continue to look for affordable housing for seniors.
Yeah, develop that project, yeah.
Yeah. And that was it.
My reports from other boards is the night before we decided we're going to go to the senior board and ask for the money.
Good. What's the status with the, there was someone who was going to update the SHI?
Yep.
I never heard anything back. I never heard anything from her at all. I got an intro by Pat.
Yeah.
And then I never heard anything about the SHI numbers for the buildings. I never heard anything about the land area stuff, so.
She didn't do the land area yet. She's still trying to figure out a couple of Heritage Lane? Heritage Lane, there's 8 units we have credit for, but we can only find 4 of them. So we're sort of trying to figure that one out. Right.
Wasn't...
And so she's updating it, but I don't think she's doing the land area part right now. I don't think you're going to get any of that on anytime soon.
Well, I think it's been almost a year now, so I just wasn't sure if she was still doing anything, so...
Yeah, but she's still... That's part of what that money is, her consulting money.
Who was the guy that was there? Because he got it all pulled together.
Dick Heaton. He's the best. But then he had a fight with everybody in town and left.
Oh. Well, everybody in town left, so maybe he'll come back.
It's true. We should see if he'll come back. No. I liked him. He was good.
He was great. He actually got stuff done. I mean,
yeah. She's doing similar. She's finishing up some of his work, like in, whatchamacallit? In Afro Terrace, where the rentals, the people are renting out the affordables and things like that. She's chasing them down.
Good.
You know,
yeah, that's a high priority. That's good.
There's 2 of them. She's written a letter that's going to be sent out to all the affordables about their deed writers have to be changed because they referenced the old address of the town hall for when things happen. They got to send a different address in, or information to a different address. And to remind them they're not supposed to rent in that letter. Meeting with housing. Oh, we had a meeting with the housing authority about them issuing or appointing the Affordable Housing Trust as the controller, sort of their land for the senior housing project, but they decided not to do it quite yet. They want to maintain control for a little while longer until we have more bids and proposals in hand. So they did that. So we're proceeding on that project with the work we're supposed to do. Environmental study. Environmental. Oh, flagging the wetlands out there. What are they called?
Geotech.
Oh, the needs analysis. Well, that's a geotech. Yeah. Needs analysis to see what it looks like the town needs as far as what the consultants would say. We should have them, those people write our housing production plan next time.
Who?
Whoever's doing this project.
That's what I was wondering.
There's a bunch that are bidding on it.
We'll figure it out. Yeah, because it sounds like they take the housing production plan, look at our needs, and update it. Because it's in the housing production.
Well, and they look at other things. They said we're going to do some more stuff. I said, well, what are you going to do? That's all census. The latest census data was used on that, and there hasn't been anything since.
There's more.
They'll probably do just a little bit more, but that's the census data that was used for that is probably what's they're going to use too. You know. That's it. And then
anybody else?
Yes. I think they are moving forward with the police station. Plan to get the bids before the town meeting.
October,
so with the bid, October town meeting with the bid, they will go back and ask for the more money. The conceptual plan, there were 3 architects came in for the senior center. Oh no, 5. The subcommittee was there.
Senior center or police?
Senior center.
That's
the conceptual. Police station is there.
There's 2 projects.
When are they coming to see us? Police station. We've asked like 3 times to have them come in and just sit down,
today,
scratch
the architect came in with a 30% plan.
All right. Sounds good.
He may go back and he will be doing the more.
Why not do it at 30%?
I think that there's no contract yet.
No, there is a contract.
No, there's a contract. The architect has a contract, but why not talk to them before he spends the other 30% to bring it to 60%, and then if somebody here, which may happen or may not, but put some idea out there that's a good idea, and he has to change all the work that he's done. If we can just look at it basically and preliminarily and say, okay, this is what we'd like, can we incorporate that? And we
have them in. Whatever the plan they have, they are going for a bid. So the bid will be in September, I guess.
Right. Well, the meeting's in October, so.
Yeah.
So there's got to be something that they pull together for the bid documents.
Yes.
So if we can review that, just so that they don't forget that they have to come to site plan review, or forget that they have to do drainage along with all this stuff, or forget.
They did mention they were coming to the planning board, but they didn't say. Yeah, didn't and I also see? They do have to go for the conservation.
Yeah, I saw.
So
is there wetland nearby?
23rd. 23rd, there is a conservation.
I thought I saw a notice for a request for a determination or something.
Yeah, it's going to be on 23rd.
I don't know.
So this side of the road.
So across the street there's wetlands? Yeah. That,
okay. Yeah. So they when they make that land in a clearing and everything, so they don't want the water to go on the other side.
Okay. Well, so, but that's, I mean...
When I was at that meeting, I was going to say that if you want some endorsement or whatever from the planning board, they didn't sound like they were together enough to come, though. Yeah. Maybe they are, but I don't think they are.
They are not ready, I guess.
Who's not ready? The architect?
Architect.
I don't think they're together.
No, he said he would be coming.
Wait a minute.
He said the architect.
Well,
he said
he would come. Well, there's one architect. Who is he not together with?
Who's that guy? Who's at the meeting?
One is the project manager.
Yeah.
The other one is the architect.
I only saw the project manager guy, I guess.
Last time, yes. This time, today he's the architect.
Okay.
His name is John.
I just fear that we're going to have some comments and it's going to be too late. Oh, we should have got that earlier. We could have done that. It's a great idea, but we're too late. We can't do it now because it's going to cost us $5,000 more and we're right at our limit right now. So
we I guarantee meetings, you that's
two meetings
happen.
In September. It would be nice to have them come to one of them.
I will pass it on.
Actually, do you want to send an email to Anita? And just say, we hear they're at 30% drawings.
Well, they're aware.
Invite them. Yeah. Well, no, a formal invitation to our September meetings.
And even just to come in as a like a roundtable type of discussion or informal discussion, not
just
a...
Just coming with a scratch plan.
Maybe they're waiting to see if the other money's going to get approved.
But they're already spending the architect's money.
And not only that.
Even more.
But what happens in October if you go to town meeting and
it wastes our time.
And the town says, no, we're not going to give you any more money.
Well, it wastes 2 hours of the architect's time before us. It. But 2 hours isn't that much.
I'll send an email to Anita.
If you would, please.
Absolutely.
And the second thing is the senior center. They do have the conceptual plan. Subcommittee picked up 3 architect firms. They are coming for an interview on what is it? All 3 will be 16th.
August 16th?
August 16th.
Tuesday.
Tuesday. Wow. All 3 they are going to find out, you know, whether they all 3 will be there.
Great.
So but all 3 will be coming. From that, you know, they will be choosing one.
So Fisk chooses that?
Yeah.
Good. The whole
good. Whole portal. And it seems like I'm not 100% sure there won't be anything in the October town meeting regarding getting money on the
for the senior center.
Yeah. Either the design plan money or total money. The reason being, you know, we don't want to make any mistakes like the earlier time. Low budget, more budget, those things.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Are you going to town meeting in October?
No, they're not.
Because we are not ready, the conceptual plan may not be ready by then.
You're still looking at a number of different locations?
It's not the place they are talking. It's not the site that they want to.
It's the
money.
The money.
How much money to go and ask the town. There is another, one other thing is also recommended to send it to the select board, which is they want to make a policy on how to proceed hereafter if we are building another building. So first we get the conceptual plan, after that go to the town meeting, get the design plan, money. Once we have the design plan money, we get the design and go get the bids. With the bids, then go back to the town, ask for the exact amount of the needed for that project. So that's going to be, that was old that was going to be recommended to the, they send it to the select board's approval.
Is there a process for policies to be reviewed by other town boards? I don't know that we ever have gotten a chance to look at them. And that's not really the most exciting, but I was just thinking about, is there a policy that comes out? I know in the
Complete
Streets, we did it. And that's why we got to see it, but I wasn't sure if there are other ones.
Yeah, I'm not sure who is going to write the policy.
Right.
But it's what it's sent it to the select board.
There's not a policy for policy approvals?
I don't know.
What?
Huh? I just see if you're paying attention, Mark.
No, it has to be approved by the select
board. No, but I thought John said that this was one who was going to write up the policy.
I don't know. No policy yet written.
So any other town boards? I did, before we get to the minutes, I did want to mention a couple of things. I think it's already been noted that Monday, the ZBA's got an instructive session.
6 o'clock.
I did reach out to Anita and say, hey, could planning board members also go to this if they wanted? And she said, yes, fine.
There's people from other towns even coming.
Oh, is that right?
How many towns?
No, that has not, no. This is.
Totally, I thought this was this one.
This has to do with special permits, variances, and open meeting law.
So I was thinking, I might like to go. I don't know if anybody else on the board would like to go, but the caution is if three of us go, then we have to post it. So if three of us want to go, that's fine, but we need to post it tomorrow.
Well, only two of you, because I'm not going to be there.
I'll say you can go for me.
I'll try to go.
You want
to
go? Yeah. You'll be there, right?
I'll be there.
Because that'll make three. So we should post that tomorrow. can we do that, Melanie?
Can we?
We can.
When we.
The royal we.
Yeah. I spell we. M-E-L-A-N-I.
That's how you spell it.
Yeah.
For us all.
So I guess it'll be an informational session.
Yeah.
Just 3 months.
Just training.
To discuss special permits, variances, and open meeting laws. And that'll be Monday at 6. So as long as we get it posted by tomorrow at 6, we're good.
Sure.
You'll
let
you sleep in tomorrow.
Yeah, I will. I'm at Boylston.
Oh, the other thing, too, staff meeting this month, too.
Staff meeting, yeah.
Do we need, when is the next staff meeting? Do we know?
It's like the third Thursday or the
Not next week. What is it, Cheryl? The 24th, right? 2 weeks from today.
Mm-hmm. 9:30 on a Wednesday morning? Or
yes.
No,
Thursday.
It's a Wednesday morning.
Thursday.
Wednesday or Thursday?
Wednesday.
It's Wednesday morning.
So. Yeah, Wednesday morning at 9:30.
Is there any?
Oh, that's right, because it's right before our meeting. Or the day of the morning of our meeting.
I think it's the 24th, right?
I think so.
Except on a normal.
That's what she said, the 24th.
I think so.
The 4th Wednesday.
Yeah, 24th sounds good.
Because it's usually the morning of our meeting, which is the 4th Wednesday. So.
Yeah.
I don't know if anybody's. Mornings or weekdays
next
are terrible.
Meeting is August 24th at
9:30. I don't know if anybody can go, but.
I'll show.
Just throw it out there.
Cheryl's going.
Huh? You're going to go? Excellent. School hasn't started?
You going to go to two?
School has not started yet. I might be able to arrange it that I could go to that one as well.
I propose.
No, but I have to work. I work ahead of time, but I can. I'm
going to
play my schedule a little bit.
Not the last time. No, 2 times ago. I went 3 months ago.
Millie, can I really press my luck with you now?
Mm-hmm.
For a second public notice for our Angel Brook walkthrough next Wednesday.
On that one.
You've got that one?
Right now.
Awesome. Because that's two sort
Don't
of.
Don't waste your chits like that.
Ordinary.
That's right.
Out of the ordinary.
You're done.
I'm done. All right.
Yeah, Raj, we're meeting, if you're interested, Wednesday at 6 o'clock at
Angel Brook
Clubhouse.
Next
Angel Brook.
Sidewalk.
This coming honest?
A week from today.
A week from today at 6.
It's 17th.
So what can meet?
It's at 6.
You're not going to make it? Your peeps?
At the selectmen meeting.
What's one?
17.
Okay.
Minutes? Any?
I do have one correction.
Okay.
So on page 4. Special town meeting on August 8th regarding TIF for UPS. That's not UPS.
Yes, that's right. It should be
so
for.
We shouldn't be saying any company name to that time. I said no company. That time
so
they
did UPS. Yes.
Yeah.
So just
I said their company.
Regarding TIF at 70 Hartwell. Okay. Just leave it like that.
Oh,
okay.
Just get rid of for UPS.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
So
next.
I just wasn't sure since I wasn't there, but on the second page, second paragraph, this is talking about VHB and the Wachusett Plaza in the last, in that whole second paragraph. We'll send plan and modifications to Graves Engineering.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't it supposed to go to VHB?
Where was it saying?
The last sentence.
Oh. But did we say?
If it is a significant change, it can be incorporated.
And maybe why VHB never got the drainage stuff.
Yeah, I think Patrick
knows
what he says.
To VHB.
I mean, isn't it?
We didn't mention Graves, though. I don't remember why we mentioned Graves.
I know, we did mention Graves.
We mentioned, yeah, but.
That was way too
much. We did mention Graves as being.
It's about, so
it could be. I know why. I know why. Because Graves is the one who did the Cumberland Farms.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
So they may have the, just to compare or something like that. We did talk
about it. Mr. Healy did in fact send the original site plan, 2009, and modifications to VHB. I mean, that was the original email that he sent to Wayne, and then Wayne reached out to us and said, what am I supposed to do with this? Mm-hmm. So I think Vinny's right. I think that should be changed to VHB.
The rest were perfect.
I like the way the expletives were done.
Was it second?
Was it
first?
First. I'll first it.
I move to approve the meeting minutes from July 13th, 2016, as amended.
Second? Or are you in second?
No, I can second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 All right. We do have, I think, a couple of bills. What's that?
Yes.
Sterling.
Oh, because we're going to face that to him.
We weren't planning on it. No, we didn't.
Thank you.
I don't think so.
What are we doing with this lady? The lady behind the where a flag is tearing down all the trees?
I have already communicated with her. She's going to the special public hearing next week.
And this lady, do we want to do anything more? This is, she's talking about.
She said, talk to the building inspector.
Do we want to do anything more than that or just leave it at that?
Well,
I mean, she knows about the
so you responded
meeting.
To.
I did, I told her, I said, bring it to the meeting tonight, but also, though, to her, we best she forward it to the building inspector since they're the ones who should go.
And she knows about the ZBA meeting. I hope that she goes to it, or knows she can go to it, you know. There's a Zoning Board of Appeals meeting regarding a request for a special permit, blah, 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 blah. I don't know if she knows that she can go. I mean, I assume she does. No, I know that. You know that. I don't know if she knows that. Yeah, we'll leave it to
she
her.
She did have the one question at the very bottom of the planning board, but she said what it read. And wanted to know, did it refer to the large numbers, 263 Maple Street, Moyer? So we're doing it for town.
How's the
plans,
town?
That's the assessors.
Which one? When's
which question was that?
169. That's a house. I don't know which one she's talking about. Oh, 14. Isn't that the one that Vinny now owns?
She's asking if the town now owns a piece.
Yeah, well, one of them is DCR, one of them is the town. I don't remember which is which. Do you remember which?
Northern portion is the DCR, southern portion is the town.
And I don't think we're doing anything with it. I mean, I think we own it.
It's open space.
It's just going to be left like that? I mean, yeah. Okay.
I think there's a right-of-way going up along the southern lot that's still got frontage. There's a right-of-way on the northern edge of that.
Right there? Oh, yeah. Through 15 or whatever that is? Okay.
Yeah. And so it's just, I think, just for trails.
Okay. I mean,
should we send a responsive, do you think? Or is that sufficient?
What do you want? What to me?
Well, you already did. Didn't you? I thought you already told her to.
She already did. Yeah, we talked about that. She already did.
Yeah, she already did.
But we didn't answer that question.
We didn't answer this question for her.
So what is the actual question?
It says.
Does the property to the south refer to the property above?
And gives the whole thing.
16914.
Above.
Property to the south, it's what you just called the property to the south.
Okay.
Which is our land, not the DCR.
Property above Maple Street rear.
Yeah.
Has the town in fact accepted this property? Does the town have plans for this property?
The Conservation Commission accepted it, I think, in August, or I'm sorry, July.
So does it refer to the property above 263 Maple Street rear?
It's.
I mean, as far as the notation in the.
There, it's south of it, not above me. So say, just reply that it's the property south of 263 Maple Street rear. And it has been accepted by the conservation.
South of 263 Maple, and has been accepted.
It's proposed use was for trails, open space and trails. But Raj will want to put a cemetery up there soon.
I need that space.
I'll send you that tomorrow.
Did they sign on our place? Oh, it's signed down here.
They don't
make it look like we needed space between on this one. Perfect.
It's not like it's going to be.
They need three signatures.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've got three. Unless you're burning
you
to sign.
We signed a couple. One was for Angel Brook,
here.
And the other one
sign
was.
Okay.
Angel Brook and Cumberland Farms.
Yep. Okay.
Okay.
Do
you want this? Is this yours?
Oh, what's that?
This was right here. Is that yours?
That's a good question.
Or was that some of the stuff that was on the floor? Oh.
No, that's what I was doing.
We talked about this.
Yeah, it's all done. I just didn't know if we wanted it.
Yeah.
I make a motion to adjourn.
Second? Oh, sorry, you can second.
You're not in charge anymore.
I'm in charge when it comes to seconding. He can't second or first.
Yeah. All those in favor?
Aye.
We are adjourned. Look, 20 minutes sooner than last time.
I know.
We're getting better.
Nice job.